What's up, everyone? It's your... Oh, sorry. Very sweaty. It's your favorite Wolf... It's your favorite Pirate Wolf Boy, Silver D Fang, saying, how's it going? I'm running late and sweaty because I went for a walk and I ran upstairs at, like, concrete stairs to get started as quick as possible. Because Vera and Perry are waiting for me. We're playing Civ more. Probably not as long as we did last time. But for a bit. Tomorrow I am doing a charity stream at 4. And Tuesday we should be doing Stray Gods. I'm sorry for being quick. I gotta cut this short because I gotta join them, like, now.
If I can get a nice
Hello.
Milfy nurse, I would be so happy. Oh, what's up, Wolf?
Yay, Milfy nurse!
Yay! We love MILFs in this house.
Oh, yeah. Sorry for running late. I went for a walk and coffee, and it took me longer than I thought, and I ran back, and I'm all sweaty.
It's all good. You didn't have to rush that much.
Well, it takes me some time to set up. I just finished setting up and telling chat, hey, this is what we're doing. Goodbye. Hi! That's pretty much what happened.
Enough. I'm just chatting with the chat as usual.
Nice. How have you been?
I've been alright. I've been being a super workhorse. Streaming and working.
I just saw your Discord message for your profile.
Oh, you mean the Twitter thing?
No, the fuck and you working on myself and looking for a manager.
Yeah. A lot of IRL stuff, and I'm talking with a lot of people in the VTube community in the background.
Good, I hope.
Oh, definitely good. I'm trying to really, like, gun-ho when it comes to my channel, you know? I haven't had as much time to do that, but now I sort of do in between night shifts.
Yeah, I think we're in the same boat. When I'm not here, I'm working. And trying to find time to do this is tough. I actually took work off tomorrow, to do a charity stream.
Oh, that's so nice.
My friend's setting it up, and she's really gung-ho about it, and I wanted to support her. I don't mind missing a shift.
Nice, shoot. Link it to me. I would love to support as well.
Yeah. Give me a second. I can do that. She would appreciate it. It's
I'm guessing, what is it, for breast cancer awareness?
No. It's to give games to sick kids in hospitals so they aren't, like, you know, bored and, like, you know, so they can still have a community as well.
Aw, it's just a sweet. I love that.
Yeah, I feel bad. I never remember the exact name of the charity. Gamers Outreach. That's what it's called.
Gamers Outreach. Got you. So I might do a thing with them too. Maybe like for Christmas or something like that.
Absolutely. If I had the audience, I would. But I'm not there yet.
I mean, me neither. But I'll do a little bit I can, if possible.
Oh, you're a better person than me.
You're like, I'm not even going to bother if I don't have the assets. But I do.
Well, it just feels... It feels like it's... At that point, it's more for me than the charity. Because the charity's not going to get anything out of it. But I will, because I say I'm doing it for charity. It just doesn't feel right for me.
Yeah, when you put it like that, yeah, you do make a point.
By the way, check the chat. I just sent the info.
Oh, bet. Also, Perry and Simon stepped out for a quick second. I think they got a phone call.
Sure.
But they were here just a minute ago. So
I did see that.
what I asked him and what I wanted to ask you for this, Jane, do you want to do anything fancy?
We can do some fun stuff. You guys know Civ 6 more than I do, so I leave it to you.
I'm trying to, like, get a little bit of ideas from you, too, you know, what might be cool, sounds cool, you know?
Give me an idea of what we're working with.
Well, one idea I definitely want to implement is the city-states. They can be Halloween-themed city-states.
Oh, yeah.
That would be cool.
Yeah, they're just, flat-out yes.
Mm-hmm. And in terms of, let's say, leaders and stuff like that, like we can get new leaders, we can add in certain wonders, we can do stuff that's anime themed.
Okay, I'm here.
A lot of things.
Hi. Hey,
what's up? All right, we had to discuss a few things with my trusted ally.
Oh, good. I can't. Oh, good. I have no leg to stand on. I showed up late.
Hey, fashionably late.
Oh, God, I wish I was fashionable. I'm just here, sweating and panting.
Oh my.
Hi, Zempty. You came at a great time for me saying sweating and panting. How are you? Haven't seen you since Tuesday.
For me, it was Tuesday.
I'm sorry, V. I'm just a horny fuck. That's what most of you in my chat are. You're no different.
I'm not streaming tonight. I'm doing my own thing.
That's all good.
You ever hear that the Squirrel Nut Zippa song, Got My Own Thing Now? It's like that, only way less rhythmic.
Here's the thing. If I had the time and this wasn't for a stream, I would love to do this off stream because I just love playing Civilization.
Yeah, I love it too, but my big thing, and I've said this God knows how many times, I'm a Civ 5 guy. Mm-hmm. Like, I this one, I don't really get as much.
We can I have Civ 5, so we could play Civ 5 next time, because this Civ 6 is already booted.
I could buy Civ 5 cheap. Like,
Civ 5
edition,
is the best. Civ 5 is the best Civ.
So I will trust you. I played it once and stopped.
It's mm-hmm. It's the best Civ, at least to me. And you're all wrong if you disagree. you just are. You just are.
I will be the judge of that.
I think for me, it was very much timing because I got Civ 5 like after a year of binging Revolution. And Revolution is very different from Civ 5, so I don't think I really gave it a chance.
I know.
Oh, yeah, it's definitely.
It's like playing Beyond Earth.
Yeah.
Wait, why isn't this happening?
I have Revolution on, like, the PlayStation, and it's like, oh my god. It's you can lose very quickly in that game, surprisingly.
Yeah, Revolution is just a whole other bag of chips.
God, if Revolution was on Steam, I would suggest it so hard. It's way... For the audience, think of it as Civilization, but 10 times cartoony.
Yes. Very much so, cartoony.
I kind of liked Beyond Earth when I played it.
Beyond Earth was cool. I think it was done better when the Endless guys did it, but it was still cool.
Mm-hmm.
There was a mod for Civ 4 that was basically Space Civ.
Oh, coats in the corner. No going to the corner. You need to be up front and center. Love.
Oh, also, Zepti, if you were here last time, I was the one bleeding. We had a barbarian issue, and I pretty much had to ask them for help, and they used it for their advantage.
I didn't do that. I helped you.
No, I'm talking to Mr. Oh, Science, I'm so far away.
What? Oh yeah.
Are you still upset about that? What do you want from me?
This is the first time I've seen you since then. So
like, I was a neutral party. I was a neutral party and all that. I just want to say,
it's like, oh my god, you need to get over here fast. You're not fast enough when you're in like Russia and I'm all the way in America.
I had no dog in that fight. I had no horse in that race.
Zepti, I was Japan, like a true Japanese emperor. I hold a grudge.
I was just sitting there playing with magnets.
And then we got space horses.
Horses, yes. Big horse. Big horse.
Space horse. Space it's horse. Like horse, but in space.
yeah, big space horse.
Oh, so I see you guys play Civ 6 a lot. So what, yes, what kind of things do you guys come up with? Pretty much just horse fucking.
Yeah, we like talking about horse fucking.
Yeah, that's the big meme, horse fucking.
By the way, feel free to invite me to the lobby.
Oh, I'm not even in the lobby.
I haven't set it up yet.
Okay. So Halloween city states.
Oh, I'm supposed to be downloading that.
I think it'll automatically download when you get in here.
I even do it just in case.
Do we want to try? Have you guys played Pirates?
Sid Meier's Pirates? I fucking love that game.
Well, I'm looking at Civ 6 and they have an option called Play Pirates. The Age of Piracy.
That's
okay.
That's very, that's like forcibly PvP.
Oh, I'll take your word.
That's like a that's like Battle Royale but pirates.
Okay.
No, not Fortnite.
Not Fortnite. God damn it, Fortnite's invading everything.
Oh,
Meyer's a playable character now.
Oh, are you looking at Red Death Battle Royale?
You can play as Sid Meier in
Wait, seriously?
No.
I was about to could you imagine?
Well, first I would have to Google what Sid Meier's looks like, because I'll be honest, when I think of the Civilization series, their mascot is Gandhi.
We'll think of like exactly what you imagine the guy who created Civ to look like.
Yeah.
Midwestern in their 60s?
Yeah, pretty much. And I mean that in the best way. Sid Meier's super.
I mean, if it wasn't for the 60-year-old Midwesterns, we wouldn't have D&D.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, yeah, boy.
I mean, you can look it up if I'm wrong. I seem to recall he looks exactly like you'd expect for the guy who made Civilization.
I was trying to think of other Midwestern things, but I can't think of anything.
Now I want to see what Sid Meier looks like.
Civilization is the only thing that's ever come out of the Midwest.
Fuck.
Yeah, Sid Meier just looks like just some normal...
That's fair. Have fun watching John Wick. Enjoy lurking. Every time you check in, you'll probably just hear horse fuck, horse fuck.
Well, we're going to try and keep that to a minimum. I think Gorgo has done good work.
Yes.
After Gorgo won, Gorgo retires.
Oh, Gorgo's not going to retire until she wins.
Well, she did win. So
no,
she
did. She did it.
Weren't you Gorgo?
Yes, and
I won.
You won with science?
Yes.
Fuck, I fought Vera.
Do you not remember how far he was?
I fought Vera with science.
I was Dizzy Miss Lizzie.
No,
I
was
Dizzy Miss Lizzie.
Okay.
Yeah, they were science, and I was going for culture.
Okay. I got you guys mixed. What I remember of...
One second.
Of Perry's strategy was being afraid of how much strength he had and how much he'd tear down.
I wasn't afraid. I had no strategy.
You were Usopp. That's what you were. You were literally Usopp. Afraid of everything, but secretly had so much influence. It's crazy.
I had no influence. I was just running around and being Elizabeth. Hold on. Let me...
Okay.
That's like Usopp literally was just like the things he did was taken way out of proportion, and now later in One Piece everybody is afraid of Usopp even though he literally does not try to combat anyone.
He doesn't try, but he still does earn it.
He does and that's
I'm sorry, what are you guys saying about me?
Usopp,
yeah, in terms of like Usopp.
Then I gotta go to the bathroom.
Sure.
I'll tell you later. Let me go in back.
So what's this mod you want me to install?
Pull it back up. Just go to workshop, type in Halloween, and it'll say Interrogan's fictional city states.
Okay, I see it.
Yes.
Okay.
I tried to find more Halloween stuff, but that's like the only four things I was there. There's also Area 51. I was like, that would be cool, but you need the DLC for that to work. So I'm like, whoa.
Ah, fuck. Damn it, I pressed tutorial.
Yo, Vera, let me get in them fish guts.
I'm gonna go to the bathroom.
Okay.
I think it's me getting in bluff guts. Get that right.
Okay, where's the workshop again? I always forget.
If you go to the game itself, it'll be like at the top. Can you look it up? It should be in community hub.
Community hub.
Or workshop.
I got single player, multiplayer, game option, additional content, tutorial, benchmark, world.
Oh, no. You have to go to Steam itself.
Oh.
Yeah. And then once you download the mod, is that the only one we're downloading?
I don't know.
I don't know either.
Let me look at some mods.
Yeah, go browse. Do your thing.
Halloween. Either way
is fine with me.
Okay, which one? Is it Enigma Conundrum? GIS America?
It's the one... Okay, like, type in Halloween, yep, and you'll see the City States one.
I typed in Halloween, and I got four options. I got Marie Lavone, Area 51, Enigma Conundrum, and Entrigan's Animation City. Oh, that's McCarthy. Ew.
It should say Entrigan's Fictional City States.
I'm here again.
Hey, hello.
I got Entrigan's Animation City States.
Yeah, that's... Oh, not...
Animation... yes, that. Yes.
Okay.
I didn't see the animation part. Yes, that.
Do we subscribe?
Yes. When you subscribe, it'll automatically download into your game.
Okay. That's going. Let's look at some of these guys.
Yeah, poke around. See whatever interests you. There's like...
I am... Oh, should we make the lobby? Because I'm ready.
In a bit. We're seeing what else we should download. Also, I added a mod to where once we start the game, we automatically get a builder.
Oh, that's neat.
Yeah,
I like that.
That'll make it go quicker.
Yeah. I figured it would. Because it's like, God damn it, we gotta build builders, and it's like, oh, well, compromise. We at least get a free one.
Is there a mod that, like, just removes that fucking thing from builders?
No.
God damn it, that would be so good.
Builders are powerful, what don't you understand?
But that's the point. They build through eternity.
They're too powerful, this game's mechanics. Too powerful.
I'm tempted to add the Tech and Civics stop reminder. A notification will pop up when a tech and civ you're doing doesn't give you a boost. No, I like being stupid.
Same.
I'll be honest. Stupid. I'm just seeing a lot of Genshin.
Of course. That's the big thing now.
Yeah, there is... You can literally have the entire game of Genshin, like the map, the leaders, the city states. Like, you can set up an entire Genshin game in Civ. It's actually pretty cool. I did a bunch of test ones, and I was just bombing people with Klee.
Honestly, I think I'm okay with what we have right now. It's going to take a lot to go through some of these, and nothing's popping out. Girl's front line.
Girl's front line, that's a cool one. There's also
there's a Witcher
VTuber one.
Going to Google that one. New civilization for VTuber.
Mm-hmm. What?
type in Mori Calliope, and then you'll get, like, all the other ones.
I don't want to be Mori Calliope.
I mean, she's a great rapper. I mean, she's not a great rapper.
She is.
No, she's not.
She's
not. Her good friend Demon Dice is.
No.
What's wrong with Mori?
Nothing's wrong with her. I just don't think she's a very good musician. That's it.
Fair enough.
Well, this was the last time we heard from Perry and Simon. He was murdered by Calliope fans.
He has been reaped. But the only reason I said look her up specifically is when you look her up, all the other ones will pop up.
But do you guys think I actually hate her?
No.
We know you mean. Of course not.
I think the only one that popped up when I wrote in Calliope was Hololive English Gen 1.
Yeah, all of them is in that one.
So, this is probably sacrilege for a VTuber. I didn't get into Hololive.
You know, I think they have some funny moments, but it's just not my cup of tea.
Honestly, me neither.
What?
I'm gonna be well. The only
I
one
think if
I
anything,
like...
I really like listening to the way they interact with each other because I like that sort of thing.
I like
kind of learning how they bounce off each other.
I like the highlights.
Yes. The only one I like really out of them, I think, what is it? Her name, Kiana, the blue one with the satellite dish.
I'm thinking Kiara.
I've never even heard of that. I've never even heard of the satellite dish.
Well, I added Kiara. It. I have yes, Hololive English Gen 1.
Kiara.
I thought Kiara was the phoenix.
Kiara is the German fox girl.
Yeah, Kiara.
Why are there
yes.
so many Kiaras?
She's the...
Because Hololive is not creative, okay? I'm just going
to
say.
I'm trying to remember.
Damn it. I was hoping that there was a V-Shoujo one. That's the group I follow.
Gen 1.
I don't know. Honestly, I've never gotten into it.
Gura. What is... That's going to bother me. What's the blue one?
I thought the blue one was Gura, because she's the shark.
Gura is one of the blue ones. Are you talking about the raindrop?
Oh my god, it's going to bother me.
I but like that literally like, none of us know any of them.
She is the crackhead of the group. Like,
yeah,
absolutely fine.
Yeah, you're talking about the raindrop from Indonesia.
Yes. Yes.
She's
so funny. That's the only one I like that much out of her.
She's quite entertaining. I recommend the animation she's a part of, made by Mr. H&H. So good.
Mm-hmm. I wish I had that kind of charisma.
Mr. H&H in general, his animations are fun.
They are.
Okay, so I'm good to go.
Okay.
Yep. So, I'm ready when y'all are.
Are we? Do you want to do the vanilla or characters, or do you want to do the Hololive?
I subscribed. I don't know if Perry did.
I did not subscribe yet. Let me. I can do that. Let me just. This is the workshop again. We're going all the way back. Hololive English Gen 1. Okay, I see it. Got it.
Cool.
Okay, right, you set that up. I'm going to change. I'm going to change my stream name.
I kind of want to make a Civ. I want to make a Perry and Simon Civ, but I would stink at that.
That would be cool if we figured out how to make our own Civs.
Yeah, it's like, what would mine be? Just science? Because brain parasite? Like, you kill someone, you take their brain?
You can either go the science route, or you can be
religion?
A civ that... Not religion?
I mean, what is more religious than complete mind control?
I mean, he's got a point.
You can do the same thing as Elizabeth. Her influence changes... She is a domination without fighting. Like, Elizabeth can convert cities with loyalty, so you can
like
have the
that.
Same mechanic with
oh,
mind control.
Yeah, that actually makes a lot of sense.
Yeah, I like that.
Now, which one is the most androgynous emperor?
Tamiris?
Okay, Vera can be Tamiris.
kind of just a Tamiris reskin. But
yours,
in the
yours is just a reskin of Gorgo. Someone just has to be Gorgo.
Gorgo. No, I would gladly.
The fan Gorgo is just all of her bonuses are related to cavalry.
It would be because like I'm a fish, she would have special like water horses.
Hippocampi?
Horses that can travel on water.
Yeah, hippocampus.
That's what they're called? Then yes.
Yeah, hippocampi. Or at least in Greek they're called hippocampi. There's also kelpies, but you don't want to ride one of those.
Why not?
Because they'll like they try to drown you.
Yeah, their whole thing is they're a mythical creature that tempts you with their horsiness to the water and then they drown you.
How can they drown me when I'm a fish?
Gorgo victim of too many kelpies.
Too many kelpies, too much water.
But Gorgo get better.
Alright, feel free to invite me now, I'm ready.
Sick. Can y'all hear these are lovely, lovely people, by the way. I haven't did an audio check.
Well,
let's get the spooks going. Hell yeah, I'm gonna play Soma. Oh lord, good luck with that. Cool.
Gorgo ascended form. She gets 100 production, 100 food from a horse resource. And 100 culture every turn.
I cannot. What do you mean? Oh, they haven't been hearing you guys. That's tragic.
That's ascended Gorgo.
Test one, test one. Speak?
Testes, 1-2 testes.
Okay.
I figured you wanted it that way. Of course I didn't want it that way. I'm having a conversation with what? The ghost? The wall?
Okay, ooh, on my screen, it is you're all ghost. Heard. And our levels are pretty accurate.
Well, now that we're starting, if you'll excuse me, I have to go do something and my friend will take my place on stream.
Oh, are you doing the Simon?
No. Hello, it is I, Dracula.
Hi, Dracula.
Hello.
Hey, Dracula.
What are we playing?
Well, when Vera gives us the invites, we'll be playing Civ.
Did we, was that Rico, or was that you that I needed to do the, unified play?
No idea.
Are you doing Mac or normal PC?
PC.
Okay, then yeah, it was Rico. Cool beans. And while I'm playing it, I'm trying to do an edit. It's going to be the most passionate edit ever.
What are you doing with the edit?
Blah, blah.
Yeah, what are you doing with the
what
edit?
What are you doing with the edit?
Don't I...
What?
I feel what? Like I should what? Have you on Steam as a friend. Where are
I
you?
I think you do. I am a real Count Dracula Vivo on Steam.
Oh, there you are.
Multiplayer.
You would be surprised how many people try to trademark Count Dracula.
Yeah, probably a lot of people. Standard rules. Gifting and a what? Followed. Standard rules.
I just now realized I should have replaced my PNG with just like a static image of Dracula.
What do you mean, Drac? You look so great with your green hair and purple slug.
Yes, we are trying a new look. Bela Lugosi did a fantastic job, but I think it's time to modernize for the modern age.
I just realized which Dracula you sound like. You sound like Nice Peter doing Dracula on ERB.
Is that a compliment? I am the real Dracula. Do you not see my username? This is real Dracula.
I mean, I like
this
ERB.
This is the actual Dracula.
They were.
You need to send me an invitation, by the way.
Yeah, I'm still sending it up.
Oh, okay.
I don't think we can do the Hololive thing, though. It requires DLC.
Okay, oh. We'll figure it out next time in post.
That is okay.
Next time, yes.
Maybe I should invite Frankenstein to the next
one. Rah!
I guess this one can be.
If Dracula is becoming annoying, do let me know and I will turn him off.
I'm okay for now. You know what, Drac? I'll never turn you off. Get your rocks off.
Excuse me?
Should I?
It's a modern age. It's the modern age, Drac. Get comfortable.
Oh, God, I just got the best idea. You do the whole thing where you're advertising like a vampire girl, like a new vampire girl VTuber. Mm-hmm. But when you turn it on, it's just someone doing a really bad Dracula impression. but still talking like a VTuber, going like, OMG, I love the chicken nuggets. Thank you for the subscribe.
Why do you do that so well?
I had a fake for a second. I'm like, is there?
I love the subscribers. I will twerk at 50 million.
I had to think for a second, like, is there a VTuber vampire? I'm like, oh yeah, shit, no.
Of course there are.
Yeah, there's a few.
Why do I know one personally?
I am aware of many. I do not know any very personally, but I am aware of many.
I'm aware of one.
What map would y'all like to do this time?
What did we do? We did.
I am okay with anything.
What maps do we have?
We have continents, we have fractal, inland sea, island plates, lakes.
Do they have Dracula's castle?
No, they do not have Dracula's castle.
I mean, you know what? That is a shame. For Dracula and Romania, let's do inland.
Inland.
No sea.
Firstly, I would like a change of scenery, but nobody asked Dracula.
Oh, okay, let's go islands, the opposite of Romania.
No. No islands. I have seen the last voyage of the Demeter. I know what ship is up there. Dracula did not actually see the last voyage of the Demeter, so we're just kind of spitballing.
Awesome.
Yes, take off score victory.
You know what? Take off science. I'm kidding.
No.
What did Dracula do to you?
It wasn't Dracula. It was the English. Exactly. Like everything, including you can agree, Drac, the English are the problem.
I agree, but your beef with the English seems to be to Simon, not to Dracula. This is Dracula. I'm a completely different person.
I forgot.
Your DNA is actually real Count Dracula.
Yeah, he actually changed it.
Yes. I am the real Count Dracula. This is, it's not Vivo, but it's...
That's fantastic, I love it.
Remember to set your difficulty to Warlord.
Yes, that's what I will do.
I will take over this, how do I take over the position?
You simply just jump into a spot.
I would like this spot. Am I on the spot? It says it is open.
It doesn't look like it.
It is open.
AI. You see, it says AI. Oh, can I hit it? It's not ready?
You know what the sad thing is? I can't tell if this is a bit or if Perry is actually confused.
Well, no, I'm actually confused. I'm not. This is not a joke. This is not a jape. This is not a jest. Count Dracula genuinely does not know what to do here.
Disconnect and then moving on. You see, disconnect. Now you got me doing your Dracula.
Oh, now there are two Draculas.
One Dracula.
Two
yes. Dracula.
And then one Count.
Two Draculas. Oh, you do it well. This is indeed some real Draculopolis. Dracupocus. You know, most people do not think that I am up to date on the dank memes, but Dracula loves a good meme.
I'm glad you do.
He likes, he's very big on Morbius. When that was funny for like 5 minutes.
I just like, I opened Fedora and I got taxes.
Texas.
There is someone I wanted to try. Attempting to locate them and it is difficult.
It's gonna be happening.
Gorgo has been good to you, I understand.
Gorgo has been a lot of fun.
Have you tried horse blood? It's rather good. She offered me a horse during the last time we met, and I wasn't quite sure what to do with it. But then I realized I can technically drink the blood. It is still enjoying the horse, so she did not mind.
She did not mind you enjoying the horse.
Gorgo, just as long as you enjoy horse. You enjoy horse your own way.
You enjoy.
That beauty of horse. All enjoy different.
So much China.
You're going with Saladin.
Oh no, I accidentally clicked on him.
Where is Sweden?
I'm trying somebody different.
I want to try Sweden. I don't know where Sweden is.
Sweden.
It is relatively close to me.
That one, I don't know.
I don't think you can place. No,
oh,
you cannot
is
place
it DLC?
Sweden.
No.
Yeah. Yes, Sweden is with the other game.
Oh, disappointing. Well then, Plan B, Bingo Bango Bongo, we will play as the Congo. Remember to set your difficulties to low.
Congo is very powerful.
I did not know, I just wanted to see Congo. Dracula takes a trip to the Congo. I have my tourist hat, my big sun hat.
Do I just want to be the worst choice and pick Portugal? One of the biggest seafaring civilizations when we're doing inland?
If you want to, this is free expression.
It's whoever you choose. Bongo, very, very good choice.
Bongos. I wanted to be Congo.
So,
I never played as Congo in anything.
So is everything gland or is there still a C?
There's a big fat C in the middle.
Okay, I can.
You should tag that you are playing with the real Count Dracula. It will be will give you big moments.
Well, if I did that, sadly Perry and Simon would lose hype, and I want to help out a friend.
That is fine. He is Count Dracula. Count Dracula, we share an account. I am ghosting his account.
Okay.
You know the Steam family plan? We have the family plan going.
Dracula is just...
Oh, I'm on Prince. Warlord.
This is the real Dracula. Do you not see the username? Only the real Count Dracula can use that username.
Apparently Portugal is not allowed. Okay.
Oh, it is. He's probably the
username. So is John Curtin, which was my second choice. One of these days I'll get the DLC. I would be, but I can't.
I recommend using G2A, because a lot of these leaders are $2 on G2A.
You could always be Gorgo. Gorgo is popular.
Been there, fucked a horse.
Some horse have nice cahoots.
They have nice blood. They have very nice blood. Very nice blood. Mm-hmm.
They
had
very...
is getting excited.
So calm down, Jack.
Oh, I'm fine.
You're supposed to be sucking blood, not pumping full of the blood.
I am scrape and lick. Scrape and lick.
Gonna be Cleo. Egyptian.
Scrape and lick.
I do appreciate that artistic rendition of the... Excuse me. I do appreciate that rendition.
First time I fought a Billy and Mandy in a long time.
It is a good show. You should think of it more often. It is a good show.
It is a very good show.
It has the brain song.
It's a jolly good show.
It has the brain song, which is one of the best things humankind has ever created.
I agree. Also, this game will start, but I will go use the fish pot.
As you may expect, Barry and Simon like it very much.
Error started game. There was an error starting the game. We recommend disabling any mods.
Oh,
and
I guarantee you that is the Hololive mode.
No, it's already disabled.
Oh, I had it enabled.
Oh.
Okay, that is my fault. That is Dracula's fault. Can you re-invite Dracula to the group?
Well, we'll have to wait for the guy who just went to pee.
I'm back.
Okay.
We had an error. Something did not work. You will need to re-invite Dracula to the group.
You also gotta invite the pirate wolf.
Yes, give me a moment. Let me see what I should disable. Ding dong, what's up, Sarge? How you doing?
Blah.
Blah, 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 blah.
Blah, blah.
I don't say, I do not say blah, blah, blah.
I say one unbroken blah. Please, please, get it right.
Understood.
You are in the presence of the real dragon.
Now, let me be so I can train my grandson on how to be a vampire.
Why would I name my son my own name backwards? That's just stupid.
Whenever and once then... you disable the mods, we start new game.
Okay.
I'll restart the game after you delete the mods.
But you can disable them and then restart.
Yes, that is what Dracula did.
Ding dong. I like you just anchored with ding dong. Just was able to get a thick dragon chick for SFM, but I gotta convert her to SMM. Would that thick dragon chick happen to be blonde with a hat and antlers?
What is... Oh. Oh, Simon likes that girl too, I understand.
Yes. I like her style.
Yes, really. That is certainly one thing to like.
You might have not to invite blonde, me again.
Dracula can think of two big reasons.
Two big? What?
Big reasons.
I know you're having
not
fun.
Not blonde, but close.
But you might have to invite me again.
Yes, please invite Dracula back to the room.
I have to restart the game myself.
Oh, okay.
Remember Taka for my sheets? No. Oh, kind of. Yeah.
This is extended lore that Dracula is not aware of.
Oh, some practice photo shoots. That is
okay. Cool. Okay. Thank you. Thank you for informing Dracula. I tend to stay in the castle and unaware of current events.
Oh, cool. A free Loki skin and smite. Oh, nice. Halloween MNC event online. For party animals. Cool, cool.
I hear if you do well in smite, you unlock the Dracula skin. For everybody.
I haven't played smite in so long.
You know the embarrassing one that Simon liked.
Well, it's her. The OG
Dota?
Name is Dola, but
no, Simon like Heroes of the Storm.
Nice. Poor Simon.
It's a good game. It is a good game.
It's Blizzard's attempt to be relevant in another.
It was
genre.
Good, but they didn't do anything with it.
Because that's just Blizzard's MO.
It was
good
it
idea.
Was fun. It was genuinely a fun game. We still. Heroes of the Storm is like we played it the other day. It is genuinely fun. It is not as serious as the other MOBAs, and it ends much quicker.
If you want a non-serious MOBA, check out Omega Strikers.
I would play Adventure Time Battle Party. Does anyone remember that?
No.
Dracula does.
Dracula,
the dramatic let's play of Adventure Time Battle Party. He get an emulator and then spend 3.5 hours waiting for a lobby.
I have been looking into emulators because I kind of want to play I kind of want to do a Solok.
A what?
Oh, Pokemon Solok. It's when you get two people and they do a Nuzlocke together.
Oh,
that sounds interesting. I'd be open for a Solok.
Dracula did some Nuzlocks a while ago. By the way, Dracula is ready to play.
I am waiting for our Audible.
I am missing Starting Builder, Expansion Rise and Fall, Expansion Gathering Storm.
Did the game rules. Download Starting Builder.
I downloaded Starting Builder.
I accidentally made the game rules incorrect.
You made them exclusive?
I made the rules incorrect. I am big dumb. I just wish someone can at least be able to make Teiyu for me. Teiyu?
Is that the Nostrite Roads person?
Does
anyone even remember Nostrite Roads? For some reason, that stands out in Dracula's head.
It sounds that's familiar. That's
how behind pop culture Dracula is.
Okay, I have starting builder.
Okay, come into the room.
The other ones cost money.
Yes. Ignore the gathering storm. I wasn't supposed to make the rules. Gathering storm.
Gathering storm is stinky anyway.
It's great that Dracula like learns words like stinky.
Yes. It is one of the first words I learned in the modern society. When I came out of the coffin, someone was actually in the area at the time, and he said, "You are stinky, good sir." And I was like, I like that word. I'm going to use it from now.
How many AIs?
I also learned the funny word Big Chungus. Would you like to know about that?
No.
I know about the Big Chungus, the big pudgy bunny.
Is that what it is?
Oh, do we want two computer princes?
No. Turn them off. Turn one off. Turn the other on.
What I like turning them on.
Okay, we can leave them on. We can leave them on. It is up to you. It is a free country.
Okay, wait. Do we want one?
Yeah, I am fine with either way. I like that there are now two Draculas in the discussion.
I was beaten this night.
I apologize. I was rather peckish. I was a bit peckish. You understand.
I don't understand. All vampires are real.
Okay, let's see. We got 9 city saves, third era, ancient era.
Part of me really wants to just like reach out to every single vampire beat overnight, or like reach out to Vixens, reach out to Lord Vermeer, just get every vampire and we just play a vampire game all at once doing bad vampire impressions.
You all just play Vampire Survivor?
Yes.
No, play like Vampire the Masquerade all at the same time, just doing vampire impressions.
Just doing vampire things.
Not even vampire impressions, just specifically Dracula. Count Dracula.
Yeah, because isn't that like modern vampires?
Yeah. Oh, I would actually do that. That is a good idea for next Halloween. I will do two. I am okay with two.
Okay, cool. I may
do that next Halloween. I will get Vampire the Masquerade and just play it as Dracula. Because I am Dracula, so of course I would be playing it as Dracula.
Of course, yeah.
And just replace the usual PNG with just a clip art of Dracula. Or a picture of Bela Lugosi.
I see your game, Vera.
What?
What?
He's playing a heavy production character that relies on desert when we're playing an inland map.
Oh, that's not fair.
Wait, what? No. Wait, does it? Wait, no, that would actually be the opposite of good. Because if we're doing inland. Yeah, if we're doing inland, then most likely they will be like lush water tiles, and that goes against me and you.
Oh,
okay. But
is inland more lush? Wrong, I assume desert.
Inland. Well, I'm just saying, if you are wrong, the Congo is going to be mad. Because I can already see the way this game is going to pan out.
I am honestly not sure. I've never played on inland before.
Well, this will be fun.
Well.
Let us groove.
You must ready up, Dracula.
Dracula is ready. Dracula is always ready. Dracula is always ready for anything.
That was Dracula's bumper sticker back in the 70s, right next to... I
put it on the bottom of my coffin. Dracula is always ready for anything.
From the first stirrings of life...
We should sell that.
Put it on a t-shirt.
Put it on a t-shirt and just have a picture of Dracula smiling. Dracula giving the finger guns. Get Dracula giving the finger guns.
From this early cradle of civilization on towards the stars. I just looked down.
There will be those who underestimate you. But you are cunning and full of tricks, Queen Cleopatra.
I want to sell that. Your now. You just get the shirt of Dracula.
Dracula.
The Dracula shirt is the best shirt.
It took an hour, guys, but we're finally in.
We have started the game, yes.
Dracula has already forgotten how to play. That is okay. He is ready.
Thank you, Civilization, for setting Cleopatra right next to a river.
Oh, that's not good.
I am right near a death. Well, no, Dracula,
Dracula is in trouble.
I think the game will automatically put you at a desirable area.
Dracula is just next to a river.
Who are you playing? Oh, you're playing Congo. That's good.
There is no rainforest.
But floods will be really good for you.
Yeah, floods count as well.
Fair enough. Dracula is pleased.
Dracula is pleased.
Dracula is pleased. You may continue your video game. If at any point Dracula is not pleased, the game will turn itself off.
Fair enough.
It is like the celebrity game grumps. They go out of their way to find a game they're going to enjoy because you don't want to make the person suffer. You don't want to make Dracula sad.
No one wants to make Dracula sad.
No, Dracula just wants to be friends.
I like the neck. Chat, I like the idea that every game I have a theme. What should Cleopatra's theme be?
Candy. Ooh, I enjoy this one.
Welcome to the capital, Snickers.
Hey, thank you for the follow, Arctic Monkey.
Oh, I love that band.
Okay, now I'm sorry, Candy, but I really want to do alternative rock bands.
Right, what theme should I go with? I'll figure it out once I get there.
I know. I'm making the capital of Foo Fighters.
Thank you for following, Arctic Monkey.
Well, thank you.
Dracula gives you a thumbs up.
You see, when the mind is too fast for us. I love Persona music, my god.
I am prepared.
Ah, yes. Is there not... There is not an area. That actually startled me a little bit.
What did you set the game speed to? Online?
Yes, that is okay. What I used.
Dracula is simply being a bit paranoid then.
I feel like that fits, actually.
Yeah, that fits a little bit.
What?
Dracula being paranoid.
Yes, Van Helsing, he's going to find me eventually. I must prepare.
Also, a really annoying 20-year-old hiker will want to date my daughter.
He's a bar mitzvah DJ. A bar mitzvah DJ, for crying out loud.
I love that you're going Universal. I'm like, let's go Adam Sandler.
I'm both. Dracula was both. I'm just that good of an actor.
Were you also
Dracula.
Whatever Dracula 2000 was? No, Bram Stoker's no. Dracula with the powdered butt monkey?
I don't recall. I seem to have put that out of my head. Now, Christopher Lee, that was him. But I taught him.
Oh, really?
I invited Christopher Lee to my castle. And I was like, so you want to play Dracula? Hmm?
Were you also Dracula and Dracula Untold?
No.
Good.
I have standards. Dracula has standards.
Yes, Dracula will only accept...
Play Dracula in good movies. Dracula was also the Billy and Mandy Dracula, if you can believe it.
The black one?
Dracula is that flexible.
I don't know why that... made me laugh like that.
Oh, I can think why.
That is something that needs to be clipped. That is something that needs to be clipped.
The black one?
Wouldn't be the first time this week I got clipped for saying stuff out of context. At least this one I can stand behind.
Oh my god.
I mean, do you know any other Draculas from Billy and Mandy?
I'm so exhausted, man.
His grandson, the nerdy kid.
It's all good.
But that is not named Dracula. He is not named Dracula. He's Erwin. Erwin is a nerd. Dracula is super cool.
Blackula.
Blackula. Oh, thank you for stopping by.
By the way, that's not me being racist. That actually, he is Blackula in Billy Mandy.
No, we know.
I know.
Oh, Blackula, no. I'm telling my chat that are probably like 20-year-olds.
Also, speaking of vampires,
Billy Mandy is from Blackula.
A vampire fanboy has just jumped into my chat real quick.
Hello, vampire. That's a combination, and I found Jerusalem.
You're a thrall of Dracula, yes?
I'm going to leave it at that because of high tensions that are going on in the world.
You're a servant of Dracula, yes? Dracula welcomes all, including the fanboys.
Yes, Dracula is very, very inclusive.
Dracula enjoys the fanboys. They're not his type, but Dracula respects all beliefs. Progressive Dracula, that's the new gag character.
Progressive Dracula.
Progressive. Progressive.
It's just normal Dracula, but he goes, okay, I'm okay with that.
It's like you would think he would be like stuck in his ways, but it's just the complete opposite.
I mean, it's cool. Your blood still tastes okay. I'm okay.
You do you, and Dracula does Dracula.
You do you, Dracula will do Dracula.
I believe in equal rights for all blood.
Dracula is advocate of true equality. Everyone bleed red.
We respect Dracula for that.
Yeah, Dracula is an ally.
Dracula is proud ally.
we stand Dracula.
Yes, as all should. All should stand Dracula.
I love that.
we do have barbarians, right?
Yes, we do.
Okay.
Dracula saw some barbarians.
Okay, already. Discipline is on then.
It is nice to have that so early.
Chiefdom? Yeah. With that being said, already better than the last game, because I have not found barbarians. I found a trade route already.
Ooh, that's perfect.
That is nice.
Come, Jerusalem, to the mighty city of Foo Fighters.
The mighty city of Foo Fighters.
Dracula has always been more of a swans person himself.
We are no pretender. We will not end the rope. We will not send you the monkey wrench. Something concrete.
Dracula is going to pretend he understands what you are saying.
Most of those were Foo Fighter songs.
No, Dracula understands. He's being in character. But he appreciates you anyway.
I understood. I was teaching Dracula. I was teaching Dracula.
Teaching Dracula how to play Civ.
How to Civ.
Civ with Dracula. That should be the new thing. Everyone should play Civilization with Dracula.
Yes. He's like, these countries are not like...
I don't know. We do not. This is not how I remember Transylvania looking. Is that person having sex with a horse? Maybe this is like home.
Yes, precisely. Sex with horse. Horses are hot.
We need to have the fated battle between Gorgo and Dracula.
One day we will have that contest of champions.
Gorgo meets Dracula. That is the third one. Have you ever seen like Billy the Kid meets Frankenstein? That is the third one. Gorgo meets Dracula.
Yeah, the 70s was really weird for horror movies.
Oh, Dracula, no. It was the time of his life. Or his death, you could say.
Ooh, these these barbarians are not as much of a problem as
Dracula. Also really liked the Mel Brooks movie.
Trying to remember. Are you talking Young Frankenstein?
Well, that one and Dracula Dead and loving it too.
That oh, I cool. forgot he did that.
Dracula really likes that one.
Craftsman.
I just noticed in the score victory thing, they removed Vivo from my name unless you scroll.
They're like copyright.
They don't believe that Dracula can be in people.
They don't believe in Dracula's music.
They don't believe Dracula has good taste in music. But he does. He does.
Which is very shocking.
Dracula has the best taste in music.
Have you heard of Pragerian throat singing?
Oh, that sounds fun. Dracula like prog rock. Dracula like swans. Dracula like
Dracula, a big fan of Yes.
Yes.
Roundabout, yes. Best song.
Dracula like Little God in Hands by Swans. Good
ooh,
song. Good song.
That is very good.
That is a good song.
Good Dracula listened to like entirety of To Be Kind on a car ride. Good, brilliant album, best album.
Oh, I didn't know Dracula had such.
Oh shit! No! I don't want you.
Dracula has come a long way from Oni Plays, where he liked the Naked Brothers Band.
Oh, I didn't know Dracula even knew about the Naked Brothers Band.
Yes, Dracula, big fan of the Naked Brothers.
Dracula loved
that was
Naked
Only Plays joke. That was an Only Plays joke, I swear.
Dracula, the based question, very based.
Dracula was big fan of the Naked Brothers band.
The Naked Brothers band.
You know, Dracula's father used to have a CD of that. Because he thought that Dracula would like it. And then Dracula didn't like it, but he thought his father liked it. So it was a really awkward situation. Like years later, we realized that neither of us actually liked the CD, so we threw it away.
But there was a good bond moment between
the two. Good bonding moment between Dracula and Daddy Dracula.
Is question out of left field, just for curiosity purposes, is Papa Dracula a DILF?
Just wondering for a friend.
Just wondering for a friend.
Daddy, I would like to fang. You know, it depends on your taste.
Daddy, I would like to fang.
You know, you want to bite him, you want to fang him, right?
Yes, I think so, yes. Very, very bangable. Production, what do I produce now?
I Minions know. For Dracula?
Not quite. Bloody Dracula.
Dracula is,
Right now, I'm kind of looking for places to have a feast.
Oh yeah, I just made the city star set. If you don't know the band, check them out. They're really cool. Big fan.
I have made Mboombi.
Boomdi?
Mboombi.
Oh, so you're not naming them after blood puns or vampirisms?
Vampire-ism.
No, I am. I need to. That is what the city is called before Dracula gets to it.
I am not sure what theme I want quite yet. I'm getting there though. Any ideas, chat? Any ideas?
Fuck it, I'll take a risk. Monument to the Gods.
Let's see. All right, we have created the city, the Vampire Club.
Ah.
It is a good song.
Do I do a wonder or do I do a traitor? I don't know. That is a good question. I could work. Oh, I have coins to spare. Why not?
You have money.
You have one money.
You have one money. You have two money. Dracula does not understand coins, so he just calls everything money.
But you understand the count.
Yes.
Wouldn't you be insulted? Isn't he like a cartoony version of you?
Oh, no. I appreciate that he is helping to teach children about numbers.
But don't you want your victims to be dumb?
Well, you can know about numbers and still be dumb.
Touché.
If anything, it gives them false sense of hope because they think, oh, I know about 1 + 1 = 2. No way Dracula can get me. And then Dracula gets them. And then they have the egg on their face.
Dracula can count up to 10.
Dracula can count up to 33.
What is the reference?
What are you going to do now, child?
He just flips off a five-year-old.
Dracula walked the streets flipping off small children. Quick,
it's
count
like,
to 30.
Not too much.
He just looks like, quick, off. Child, count to 30.
Oh, you can't be the arch?
Oh, you can't. And then Dracula walk away. Leave. They live with their failure. Okay, I need to take a break from Dracula.
Are you getting lightheaded?
A break. A lightheaded.
No, Dracula just turned into a bat for a bit. He'll get better.
I do. Okay, so for chat, if you don't know, Perry is the little purple slug thing on top of the British dude. So I like imagining just he went every time he talked like Dracula, his whole body just vibrated to get that like deep Dracula voice. So all you just see is this giant blob go brum, brum, brum.
Well, no, I had nothing to do with that. That was literally Dracula. Dracula.
Yeah, that was the Dracula. I don't know.
Yeah, no, I don't know what you're talking about.
Yeah.
Simon had nothing to do with it.
Simon wasn't even here at all.
That was real Dracula.
So I like my imagination more than his imagination. I like squeaky toy Perry. But yes, that was Dracula.
Ladies and gentlemen, Dracula. Be sure to
also
sure to
ladies
follow him on Vivo.
Also, ladies Dracula and gentlemen, Vivo. The Babylon.
You mean the Hanging Gardens?
That one too.
I suppose I should build a wonder too.
No.
Oh, Hanging Gardens, I see. Okay, I see you.
No, don't look at me. I'm hideous.
No, you're a very handsome wolf. I beg to differ. I just need to look a little more, you know? Just doing a little bit of spying, you know.
How do you have spies?
I don't. I. But I love the fear. I love the quick fear.
Yes, the fear was impressive.
Yes, very impressive.
Barbarians are approaching Dracula's territory.
It's one of them named Dave. If his name's Dave, don't worry, he's a coward.
No, I do not think this is Dave.
Really good at calligraphy, though.
This does not look like Dave.
Dave, the barbarian. Bubba.
I have gotten a boost.
No, see, I know what you're talking about.
Oh, I know you do. I know you do. I'm just now one of
the... Hit him with
the
hammer.
It's a good theme song.
Oh, that was
barbarian,
a good show. That's one of those shows that, like... I'm sad that it never got picked up
for more.
Yeah.
Or that kind of got like screwed over.
I didn't realize it until like Wikipedia. They only got like one season and like 26 episodes.
What? Yeah, it's kind of like you know the one that I thought was interesting recently? A fucking Chopsocky Chooks. I had like a memory of that and I'm like, was that real? So I went and I looked, and it's honestly not a bad show if you put aside the fact that one of the chickens is like very clearly doing a racist accent.
I couldn't get into the art style.
I kind of like the art style.
I saw a couple of episodes.
It was unique at the very least.
Oh, absolutely. Definitely. But they also
I did like the villain. The villain like absolutely fucking nailed it. Yeah, yeah, the evil girl coming in. He's like, do you know how many times I have like crazy goth chicks coming into my house? You're going to have to be more specific.
It was Doofenshmirtz before Doofenshmirtz.
Only the like actually people. Successful and not a good father.
Yeah.
I kind of like that. Like the
voice is that you?
I kind of like the fact that the villain already owned the mall and everything. And like it. Why are you doing evil plans, dude? You've already won.
I mean, those are always fun in cartoons.
You already have all the money. You don't need more.
I'm going way back.
But why not? There's never enough.
Before, I'm pretty sure any of us were born, but do you guys know the Cowboys of Moo Mesa?
I saw the funny Nostalgic Man's video on it, so yes.
Okay.
That's foreign to me.
Okay, so, well, I'll finish what I was going to say, and then I'll tell you.
The cold of the West. Yeah.
So, the villain was pretty much the mayor. And I'm like, why are you trying... Like, you're already the mayor of a Old West town. You own everything.
Mm.
So, now for Vera and everyone else. Cowboys of Moo Mesa was a cartoon show from the early 90s about a meteor that altered... some animal genes and made them human-like. So the cowboys of Moo Mesa are literally cows that are boys, but also cowboys. It's a play on words.
All I remember is that they talked about the Code of the West a lot.
Yep. Yeah. One of the leaders had a book called The Code of the West, and he would follow it, and everything had to do with the Code of the West.
So it's literally the equivalent of like Dear Princess Celestia or something like that.
Dear Princess Celestia, back in the old DuckTales, the Woodchuck guide.
I liked the new DuckTales when I saw it.
Oh, it was amazing. I watched all of it.
Oh, yeah.
My friend had me watch it, and fucking Glomgold absolutely stole the show. But I loved the whole, like, who's the evil twin? And then everyone just in agreement, Louie.
Oh, 100%. Louis. Oh, you
and
mean
like, yeah, can't just argue. Like can't argue with that. Like, yeah.
Oh, do you mean Danny? Argue. By the way, by Glomgold, do you mean Danny Baloney?
Duke Baloney. That was it.
Oh, it was Duke Baloney.
It was Duke Baloney. That I remember. It was Duke Baloney.
Nah, that show was great.
And the whole plot of that was like, do we really want to make him the asshole again? Because he seems perfectly happy.
Yeah.
The most entertaining characters, at least to me, are, like, creative assholes.
Oh, no, I love the fact that, like, the reason Glomgold's evil plan worked against the super smart villain was because it was so fucking stupid that they couldn't imagine it being a thing.
Yeah.
The super smart villain was like, no, this isn't your plan. This can't be your fucking plan.
I need amenities. Ew.
Someone built the pyramids. Congratulations.
Nice. Wasn't Egypt.
Wasn't me. It wasn't Transylvania.
Ooh, hold on. This on all marsh tiles. Where can I build this? There? Where can I build that? Take over. See, I don't want to remove that. Oh, I don't want to have less food. I'm conflicted. Might have to sacrifice some food, unfortunately. I don't want my people to starve.
Oh, my people are not entertained.
My the vampire club is not happy, but screw them. That's why they wrote a song about them, because they suck.
Must be built on blood planes or orange. Just so I can get more teleport, I'll go there. Oh, and I can get a pantheon. Nice.
You know, I keep forgetting that the tiles culture bomb, that wonders culture bomb.
Yeah, depending on where. On Marsh Plain and Flood Oasis?
I really hope we don't have another situation where one of you is just conquering everything, because I just have a question mark for everything.
No, I'm not doing anything. I'm just kind of messing around right now. I don't actually know what my strategy is going to be.
Me neither. I'm kind of just building stuff and then just seeing where I go
from there. I have a vague idea.
Mm-hmm. But yeah, it's like vague.
With that being said, I just found barbarians.
Yeah, I've got some harassing me right now.
I killed mine right out of the gate, so they're not bothering me. Marsh and Oasis production with fishing boats. Do I have a lot of marsh?
Randy Marsh?
Yes, Randy Marsh. I want him as part of my civilization.
Oh, no.
Randy Marsh?
You never want Randy Marsh.
Well, no, he'll come to your civilization. He'll go like, I'm sorry, I thought this was America.
This is fucking America. And starts beating up my people.
Yeah. You'll send an infantry to kill him and he'll just get back up. I didn't hear no bell.
And then he'll do cock magic.
Over here, you got your white planeswalkers.
I guess I'll go with this one. You know, white just walkers.
I'm sorry. The fucking this. I didn't hear no bell. Was still the best to me. I didn't hear no bell.
When I still think of Randy Marsh, I still think of, like, the over-the-top takes everything, even the most ridiculous situation, serious.
Mm-hmm. Like, oh, no. That was so good, because he just fought other people's dads.
Do you remember the public swimming pool episode?
Yeah, I do. That was the piss one, wasn't
it? Yeah, and he gets a monkey to pee on him, because in his head, it's like, I'm going to sacrifice myself for my son. Does nothing. But he just gets peed on by a monkey.
Oh, Randy is a great creature. As a magical creature.
We all love Randy.
I haven't watched the latest episode, but I did watch the Watch Mojo of it. In the latest one, he goes through a broken oven to find multi-universal handyman, because the handyman in his world became billionaires because no one remembered how, because no one knows how to, you know, like, do basic matins for themselves, so the handymans became rich.
Hey, I can change a light bulb.
I know how to change a light bulb. I know how to change people.
I do. I changed the light bulb. I changed the light bulb today.
Did you do it, or did Simon do it?
That's the question.
I mean, Simon did it. But I know how to change it. That's the important thing.
How
to change it.
In theory, you know how
to. I don't have hands. What do you want me to do?
What did your people do for a light?
Fluorescence.
Oh, shit, yeah. No.
That was like one of the first things we did. We made, like, auto-turning on lights.
You can get fluorescence for your place. Why don't you?
Because fluorescence costs money.
Do you not?
Didn't you bring any with you?
Yeah.
No, of course I did, but this world doesn't take brain bucks. So what the hell am I supposed to do?
Also, just made another wonder.
I was working on one, and then it got salvaged. I didn't finish it in time.
I just like the sound, because I hear it, and I'm like, Jesus?
Jesus, is that you? I get additional for that one. Ooh.
Okay, this is actually an issue.
I am making smart people in my civilization.
I don't think I'm doing anything right at the moment. It's really tricky to learn how to play a new civ.
It is. You really gotta, like, kind of just look back and forth and see what their stuff, like, is. Like, what their best thing.
Oh, you son of a bitch.
And build them. Son of a bitch? Who's the bitch that they're the son of?
The scout just entered my my area and is, like, pillaging my farmland.
Oh, no. That's not good at all. I might need to make another settler. I only have, like, 2 cities. I mean, they're doing pretty nice. They're eating well. I like to feed my people. I love to stuff bananas and chocolate.
My cities are actually not doing very well.
Just, would you like some bananas and chocolate? I can help you.
Oh, no, I am okay. I am okay.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I'm okay for the time being. Okay. It's just one of those where it's like I'm trying to find my footing on the map.
Got you. I just like to eat. I don't know. And I like to share my gluttony. That's what my civilization is just going to be, just gluttony.
But I just want to eat.
I just want to eat. Just food. Nothing else. Just food.
Reminds me of, did you ever see the Moomins? And they're like, hey, I'm gonna give you all the money in the world if you help me with my bag. And the guy's like, but I just want to fish!
No, wait, what was the movie?
Moomins. Fantastic series, but, one of the characters, Snufkin, doesn't give a shit about anything, and I love him for that. Because he'll just be like, he'll just show up and vanish, and that's just what he does. Everyone's used to it. It's like, oh, Snufkin's leaving again. All right, see ya, man.
How do you remember a lot of these? Like, I just looked up and I'm like, oh, that's so, it's like childhood.
Because the movements are fucking great. They're still a thing.
Really? Are they still doing and producing stuff?
Yeah, it's like an icon of Finnish culture. I have a stuffed Moomin. I have one.
Video? I mean, pick or no poop? I must see the Moomin?
No, like, I'm not sending you a picture of my Moomin. You can't just ask a man to send you a picture of his Moomin. Come
yeah,
on.
Yeah, that's low blow.
Fair enough.
Yeah, I gotta trust you a lot to show you a picture of my Moomin.
I mean, but I bet you could have a very nice Moomin.
It is a very nice movement, but it's a very nice movement.
How big is your movement?
It's about a little, I'd say above average. Above average size movement.
Oh, nice. Why wouldn't you want to share it with the world, you know, the confident movement?
Well, I mean, of course, I'm confident in my movement. I mean, you kind of have to be confident in your movement in this day and age. But, I don't know. You know, I'm waiting for the right person to share that movement with, you know?
Fair enough. Any suitors for the movement?
Any what?
Anybody have your eyes to share the movement?
Nobody right now. You know, we kind of like keeping our movement to ourselves at the moment. I'm probably going to have to put it away for November, though.
So, guys, just, you know, I'll be right back. It's going to go to the washroom.
You know, Moomin's got to hibernate in November. You know how it is.
Understandable. You know, gotta keep the Moomin warm, you know?
Yeah, I got to keep it snug.
Just the snug Moomin.
Snug Moomin is the best kind of Moomin.
True that. Production towards buildings. I'm just kind of building job. Maybe I've spread.
I'm so busy trying to fight off barbarians that I haven't had the chance to do anything.
Hmm. Make a nice little army for yourself.
I'm trying, man. That's why I always hate dealing with these guys.
Yeah, it will always be a pain in the buns. It's inescapable. Research the construction technology. Do I? How close am I am to construction? Not even close. Not even close.
What's that thing I'm supposed to be?
I'm surprised I haven't found any of you guys yet, considering...
Oh, I've no, I found you. Thank
you. Found me?
Yeah, I think so.
Hello, Mombit. I will send you a delegation.
Okay, I will do the same.
No, only I send presents, not you.
Oh, I mean, you know what the greatest present of all would be?
Chocolate.
No, assistance getting rid of these damn barps.
Sorry, guys, I am back.
You can see me, but I can't see you. I'm afraid I cannot.
That's okay.
You don't need to.
Well, so my civilization is growing. I have an 8 city.
Wow, Jesus. My highest is a 5? I am really sucking this game.
Who are you?
Dracula.
What your best thing is, you're really good with food to start off.
No, I'm not.
Fast. You should be good with food.
No, I'm not. I don't know what it is.
Do you have a lot of wheat piles, bananas around you?
I have like one wheat. It's mostly like ivory and horses and stuff.
So you have horses.
Yes, I do have this.
Just for a second, Gorgo comes back. I heard horses.
Horse? Me hear horse?
I hear horse.
Gorgo hear horse?
Gorgo immediately, I hear horse. I must go to horse.
Wherever horse, there Gorgo.
Horse is a horse. Gorgo is ultimate quantum leaper.
So that's when we're talking about Civ mods, we should just make like Gorgo Ascended. Horses give plus 1,000 of everything per turn.
No.
She is just a deity when it comes to horses.
We just turn all of the
Gorgo, all resources become horses.
We turn all the rulers into horses.
Everything.
Abraham horse.
Gorgo make everything horse.
Everything horse in Gorgo.
All horse under Gorgo.
Gorgo make all horses. Somebody made hanging gardens.
Yeah, like turn 8.
Oh, that was a long
time. Yeah.
I haven't even bothered making hanging gardens. I should, can I?
Well, not anymore, I can't.
Yeah, I can't.
Okay, fine, let's just get this out of the way.
I forgot it was even a thing. That evil little snicker. We're all very close in score. That's good, that's good. I have just passed someone, though.
Oh, I met someone new. Hello, Nanmadol.
Nangmondal. That reminds me of Mungdal from Chowder.
Oh, god damn it, there's another fucking barbarian encampment. I hate these guys.
Advice, whenever you clear an encampment, keep that soldier there so they won't ever bother spawning in that area.
Oh no, it's I think it's the same encampment, they just won't stop sending people out.
They are probably scared, as they should.
I just realized
Dracula is watching them.
I just realized I'm fucking Egypt. My whole thing is rivers, and my settler is going into the Arctic tundra. What the fuck am I doing?
That is not where you want to be. Not in the slightest. Where is my? I'm trying to find where you guys are. Oh, my scout, there's a lot of barbarians. I got to mosey on out of there.
Change my government. Give me. What do I want here? I guess we'll do that.
Oh, my scout is in danger. That's a dead scout if I ever seen one. Damn, that sucks. Must be adjacent to an entertainment district only within the city. I'm not getting anything from that, so I'm gonna put that there, and I'm going to continue to run away.
They're just ganging up on me. I don't think I can beat these guys.
I think I figured out what I would like to do. But barbarians are now becoming a problem for me, too.
Yeah, God.
You dang give me barbs. I don't need money. Who needs money?
I would like some money.
Who needs money? I'm joking. I don't. If I was rich, I would spread my wealth all around and all over.
If I was a rich man, da 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 ba da ba da ba da ba da ba da. Am I the only one a Fita nerd?
No, I know it. I know the song.
Not a nerd per se, but I am aware. I shouldn't have a naked settler. This is risky, but it'll be fine. I cannot allow this man to keep baring his cheeks in that manner. I'm still doing the goddamn voice. See what you did?
I stopped doing the Dracula a while ago. Dracula's taking a break. He's chilling out.
Yeah, but now I can't stop doing it. It's kind of entertaining.
That was my plan this whole time. Distract you with Dracula voices.
Chat, I know I made a mistake, successful. And rather than owning up to it, I am... My settler is going everywhere.
They're just doing it their thing.
Well, I hate doing cities nearby each other, but if I'm Egypt, I kind of need to be near rivers, and Jerusalem already took like a really good river spot.
Mm-hmm. Well, it would definitely be in your benefit.
Yeah, so I'm leaving the settler. the settler was in the tundra, and I'm like, okay, backtrack.
That's good. That's good. Make sure they have the utmost backup. I might need to extend. Also, sometimes it is good to have cities near each other because you can swap the tiles amongst your cities.
Yeah.
So if one particular city is lacking something, you can swap that tile to that city.
Believe it or not, I don't think I know how to do that.
Oh, shit.
Once your cities are connected to each other, like the borders are connected, you can do that. So that's a benefit of actually putting two cities next to each other.
Fucking hate barbs, man.
Yeah, get dadgum and barbs.
Yeah, the barbs near me have horses.
They're making them faster than I can kill them.
Mm-hmm. Are they trying to attack your city?
But I think they're about to grab my settler.
They were attacking my wonder.
Ooh. Yeah, then a wall would be good ASAP.
Oh, yeah, I already built it.
Nice, nice.
Yeah, no, my capital is almost level 10.
Bluff Knight, do you have an idea? Do you have an idea on what should I theme my cities? That is a dangerous, dangerous place to be. Oh, I'm scared. I'm scared. I'm quaking in my boots.
I got government.
Yay.
I got government. Got a lot of government. Running parliament. Got a lot of government. I want to make an improvement there, but I don't want my freaking, builder to get yayoinked. Maybe the fish theme isn't the way to go. I don't know. Something potentially clever. Or maybe fish puns, I'm thinking. I don't know. Or maybe an anime?
Oh, come on. I swear, they've got like three fucking different barbarian encampments near me. Ooh.
The early years aren't looking so good for you.
No. No.
Just wait for your wonder years.
Yeah, I'm waiting on those.
Mm-hmm. Bink. Another unit that needs murder.
That's right, you better run.
Sorry, no, that was the first thing that came to mind. See the sea? What? I got a perfect idea to name it. I should be able to do special characters, right? No, I can't. There we go. Perfect. Perfect name for me. Don't say anything, chat. Yeah. Say
chat.
Say nothing.
Hey chat, do you want a sound alert?
That's not how it works. You can't just keep bribing people with sound alerts. One day it's not gonna work.
I would say it didn't even work the first time.
Inside me for real.
Is that how you're bribing them?
No, you don't know that. You know what I'm doing?
Bribing them with being inside them.
I mean, it's a really good form of convincing, I'd say. You know.
In chat. He does have an advantage because he is a bisexual sweat dream, so he goes for both.
Exactly.
Hey, no, you got an unfair advantage here.
That is your catchphrase, right? I'm trying to do free promotion for you.
I'm splendors for all genders. So yeah.
Oh, you got a new one. Okay. Sorry guys,
that's been the thing.
I'm on Summer's catchphrase. He's on Fall's catchphrase.
Yes, exactly. See? No.
Let me figure out what the hell I'm doing.
Alright, defending myself against these villains. Let me send this owl. I'm sending my settler far, like really far, but I have a good idea in mind. I'm trying to get me rice. That's like a little bit of rice, you know, in my palate.
Start the route.
I finish apprenticeship. Good.
Okay. Oh, goody, I just found the barbs.
Made nice the city of that. Paramore.
Unit needs orders. Oh, my traitor needs orders. I forgot you existed. My apologies. Oh, what are you guys' plans for Halloween, by the way?
I'm streaming Stray Gods with a friend of mine.
Yeah, the new Age of Empires 2 DLC is coming out on Halloween, so I'm going to do that.
So we're doing lame things. Are you going that in party?
Excuse me, Age of Empires 2 is not lame.
It's hip.
It's hip with the kids.
All I'm really doing is just binge-watching horror movies and eating snacks with my roommates.
I mean, that sounds fun.
Yeah, it sounds awesome.
Oh, yeah. I mean, kinda, yeah. We've made a, so we draw on our mirror, in our bathroom mirror with a marker, right? With dry erase marker. And what we did is each of us picked 3 horror movies to watch, and we are watching them in order based on their Rotten Tomato score.
Oh.
Right. So it goes from, like, the first Scream, which is like a 60, no, which is like a 70, up to Get Out, which is like a 98.
Get Out's amazing.
It is. It's really good. I haven't seen
it. So, I don't think this is a contradiction with the 98. I think it's overrated.
Get Out? Really?
Yes. I don't think Get Out is bad. I don't think it's a 98. I think it got really hyped because it was the first that really did something that a lot of people were asking for, which was, not even nuanced, but very... politically,
you can say it straight up. It's one of the first black famous horror movies. Like,
yeah,
it's a very black movie.
Not just black, but very black culture.
Yes,
because it's not really a horror movie for everyone. It is like a horror movie for a certain
demographic.
Now, let me say, it was needed, but I don't think that... I think most of the characters are bland to me. I think the comedy is awkward and forced. But with that being said, I think the horror elements are really good. What Peele is trying to get at, I think is really cool. I like the whole hypnotic scenes.
Mm-hmm.
I just don't think it's a 98. I think people... really wanted something like it, so when they finally got it, they kind of forgot, you know, its imperfections.
I think that's fair. That's a fair analysis on it. But like, I've never seen it myself quite yet, so I really don't know.
But you called it good,
right? Well, okay. Good in from like, because I saw a little bit of it, right? And the bit that I've seen,
just waiting on y'all now.
I haven't finished. Like, I maybe saw the first, maybe 30 minutes to 45, and I was entertained.
So
I never saw it all the way through.
In chunks, it's a good movie. It's when you see it all. It's like anytime they go back to the friend, I'm like, okay, this is Peele afraid to go full horror. So he added a comedic character that just does not work. And he comes up a lot.
Playing with comedic timing in horror movies, it's very hit, miss, and risky. A lot of the time, so... I really hope that doesn't ruin it by that standpoint. Oh, wow, my scout was... Ooh, I have a great person. That's my first great person. I can go see what the list of stuff is.
Yeah, go for it. I'm a giant movie dork, so I like hearing stuff like this.
There we go.
Okay, so in like order, from worst to best, we have Scream 4. Which, I mean, it wasn't great. Scream 4 wasn't great, but some of the comedic timing in that movie made me personally love it. Especially the opening scene, it made me die for literally 5 minutes straight. I don't know if you've seen that one.
Scream 4, no.
No. Well, there is a scene, right, where they were kind of... It's like the teens were watching a movie, right? And it was these two girls eating popcorn, right? And as the blonde chicks were talking, one was complaining on how predictable the movie was. She's like, the scares aren't realistic. You can see things happening a mile away. Like, you always just see it coming. And the moment she says that, her best friend turns and stabs her in the stomach.
So, I haven't watched Scream 4, but I have watched Scream and Scream 2. And, like, if I remember right, Scream 4 was kind of the, like, after, like, 15 years, like, brought back. Like, and, yeah, that's what Scream was originally. Scream was poking fun at the cliches of horror at the time.
Yes. And it did it, like, in a very... Oh, my scout's about to die. It did it in an extremely entertaining way. That's what made me love Scream, right? But it's, like... 3 and on was kind of making it a little overdone until 6. Like, I really love 6 because 6 was the making fun of tropes, but knowing those tropes and breaking those tropes. Like, they're like, you would never see a serial killer grab a shotgun that a police officer dropped and actually go after people and use it. Nor have I ever seen a Scream be able to, like, kind of throw hands with his knife. That's new. It did very new stuff that made Scream feel fresh.
That's fair.
Most of the other entries.
Oh! Oh, hello.
Smart serial killer, basically. They were very smart.
Hi, Raiders. Hey, buddy. How'd you go? What were you up to? Just playing... Just playing Civ with Perry and Simon and Vera.
Then the real Count Dracula.
And Dracula, he comes in and out. Right now he's taking
the real, this is he's the taking, real Dracula.
What were you Raiders playing? And also, hi buddy. Or Bub D. Hi Bub D.
Hey, what's up, Bub D?
Where were you up to?
Hello, Bub D.
We were playing Cuphead. Oh, I fucking love Cuphead.
Dracula loves Cuphead.
One of these days, I really should, just from the beginning, stream it. Because I still haven't played the DLC.
The DLC is great, but it makes Dracula very angry.
Why?
It is hard.
Oh, yeah. No, I've seen the whole DLC played, so I understand. Yeah, no, some of those guys are fucking insane.
Dracula is frustrated.
The chef is, like, I get it, he is the final boss, but Jesus, that chef is tough.
It is really just the first stage, honestly, there.
Oh, you had issues with the gnome giant?
No, the first stage of the Dracula part, or the final boss.
Oh, I mean...
The Dracula boss, yes. You can fight Dracula on Cuphead. It's very secret.
It's like fighting yourself.
Well, only if you are Dracula. Otherwise, it's, you know, you're fighting Dracula.
Oh, why does Angel hate the DLC? I think the DLC was well done.
The DLC is very good. Dracula likes the DLC.
Look, any time where we have 1930s bug gangsters, I'm all for.
Oh, that was such a fun mission.
Also,
Cuphead took me hours.
I'm not actually a furry, but this sentence is not going to help me. The dog pilot, I just like that she exists.
That is a dog, good sir.
I'm a wolf.
It's a wolf, that makes sense.
Well, fair enough.
We're cousins.
I'm just informing you that it is, in fact, a dog.
I don't think you should say your cousins.
Well, we're genetic cousins, but we're like 20 removed.
I mean, if you say you are cousins to the dog, that only kind of makes things worse.
We're 20 removed cousins.
That's what they all say to justify, yes. But it is fine. It's fine. just a little saucer.
Not Einstein. Einstein was nothing removed. You guys know that, right? He married his cousin.
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
I mean, they did some really weird stuff around that.
Yeah.
Very weird stuff.
It was weird. Yes. Dracula was there. It was weird.
Dracula was friend. He brought bean dip every Saturday.
Dracula introduced those two. Biggest regret in life. Odd life.
Yeah, it was there since the beginning.
Where's your platinum?
Look at the photo gallery. Dracula is always in the background.
I was also there during Communist Party for Oppenheimer.
If you look during picture of Stalin shoving man off boat, Dracula is in the background winking.
I was in that weird conference hall while his wife imagines him fucking his girlfriend. That scene was weird.
Dracula was there giving finger guns to camera.
Giving finger guns. I really love that, and we all know the fact that you can't even see Dracula in the photos. That is
yes. That is. I can't believe someone beat me at Colosseum. I really like Colosseum.
That was me.
Wait, what? I wasn't allowed to build it. Fuck. Okay, so that actually explains a lot. I thought I did it because I was. Two turns last time I checked.
Nah, I went straight.
You son of a bitch. You son of a bitch. Yeah. I was two turns away and then I got like, oh, you can do a new production. It's like, oh, I guess it got done.
Nope.
But I didn't hear the Jesus music.
I put it in my my First Nation is like really good with making wonders. Really? Somebody is very far in culture.
Not me.
That is not Dracula.
That is Dracula. That
no,
is
it is not. Dracula yes, is busy fighting barbarians. Dracula is literally just fighting barbarians at the moment.
It is you. Yeah, it is you on the map. I see.
I have only met two city-states. How many do we have?
There are probably like six.
There's nine.
Yeah, I've only seen two.
Same, I've only seen two.
Also, the barbarians left me alone.
Ooh, that's good.
Okay, it was good seeing you, buddy. Thank you for the raid. Enjoy sleep.
Sleep is very good.
I don't know why, but Dracula's having a really rough time this game.
Poor Dracula. I wish I could help Dracula. I feel bad.
I need to create a juggler. All my places have like no amenities.
Hey, let me you want to hear a joke? Dracula would tell you a joke.
Okay.
What do vampires do at the carnival?
Suck.
They go for the juggler.
Ah,
I see what you did there.
Yes, I am sure you do. Dracula is quite funny.
Dracula is funny now.
Dracula made the funny. Dracula is the maker of the biggest funny.
He's quite the funny, quirky vampire.
I am very quirky. I am not like other vampires.
Get you a vampire like Dracula.
Dracula is skater girl. See you later, girl.
See you later, girl.
Dracula is skater. He says, see you later, girl.
Dracula... Oh, Dracula. So,
have you ever seen on the topic of weird, like, just dumb characters, like the whole, like, not like other people? With the 100 Girlfriends manga I like so much, there's a character that I think is fucking funny recently named Kiki.
Okay.
And her whole thing is she wants to be, like, known as a weird genius. I mean, she's already a genius, but, like, she wants to be known as a weird one. So she does things that are like, oh, look at this, I'm so special, isn't this weird? But none of them are actually weird, and if anything, they're just either, like, annoying or nonsensical. So it's like, look at me, I'm eating with my chopsticks upside down. Isn't that weird? And everyone's like, I mean, honestly, it just seems more impractical than anything. Yeah, but it's stuff like that where she's like, by the way, what, how do you guys eat your taiyaki? It's like, oh, I do the head, I do the tail, I do the back. I start eating mine from the anal fin. Isn't that weird? It's like, I guess. It's just like, I mean, it's nothing crazy. It's just like, it seems inconvenient, if anything else. If nothing else.
Yeah, it's like, why would you purposely try to do that to yourself?
I mean, her attempts at being unique are just entirely cringeworthy. They're either cringeworthy or just pointless.
Mm-hmm.
But the joke is, literally every other member of that fucking family, of that harem, is weirder than her.
The one who is openly
trying to be weird is the least weird.
Because sounds about
it's
right.
It's just natural for them.
Yeah, and the joke is like, she seems rude when she's calling you abnormal, but it's like, oh no, she admires weirdness. She admires abnormality. So on one hand, you know, when she's calling you that, it's a compliment. But on the other, accepting that compliment means you accept you're abnormal. So it's like, you know, which way do we go here?
Which way do we sway? How long is it's one season, right?
The anime just started. It's episode 4 is just dropped. But the manga is like 150 chapters now.
Is it like well, I'm probably gonna pirate it anyway. But like, is it like on Crunchyroll or something?
It is on Crunchyroll. But I think right now they're only about to get up to Girlfriend 4. So they're not going to make it to Kiki for ages. Kiki's 26.
Ironically, though, so do you guys know the website Anime Trends?
Yeah.
So they keep track of, like, well, at least from their, like, the people who, you know, take part in it, what people are watching in each week. 100 Girlfriends, I think this week is number 5.
And I'm telling you, the minute they do like the best boy, best girl polls,
People are gonna blow up, probably arguing about it.
Well, if they're gonna pick, I know that they're gonna pick, like, you know, Yor and all that, since it is Spy X Family season 2.
Damn right.
Yeah, I would pick Yor.
100%.
Why?
No. I understand. I understand the Yor. But I'm saying, best boy, Rentaro has to win. There's no other option.
I don't know, man. I kind of really like Ragna.
You don't understand. You don't understand the power of the love monster.
You don't understand this dude who sacrificed his future to make sure that his childhood friend had a future. And will fight dragons to save her.
Rentaro literally punched out the embodiment of common sense to make sure his anime would happen so he could get to see his girlfriends animated. He fought common sense and won.
The Kumagawa logic, as I would like to call it.
I mean, that actually happened in the manga. He fought common sense and won. Rentaro's whole joke is he can literally do anything if it's for the sake of his girlfriends.
I meant Gandhi. Oh god, Gandhi's in the can.
Yeah, I noticed. I'm trying to keep good terms with him.
But with that being said,
he scares me.
The number one anime is not actually a sequel.
Yeah, I know. It's Journey's End, right?
Yeah, Frayrin. Okay. Which, okay. As someone who... I'm not watching the anime, but as someone who's read the manga, deserved.
Yeah, fair enough. I don't know. I'm not as big into, like, action or isekai stuff anymore. Or it's, fantasy as much.
It's fantasy, but what it is more is it's slice of life.
Okay, that sounds kind of fun. I'll have to give it a look. But no, I love Kiki just being needlessly smug about stupid shit. That's right, I start from the anal fin when I eat my food. Aren't you jealous? No. What's, it's
the
not even like
anal fins.
It's not even annoying. It's just like, why? There's no reason for it.
Does there need to be in?
Well, no. The best part of it. The best part of it is, she learns that all 25 of the other girls are weirder than her. And then she goes to Rentaro. She's like, okay, well, you know, I can understand everyone. I'm still not entirely sold on you. I don't really see why you're weird. I mean, I guess it's weird to date all these girls, but, you know, harems are a thing, so.
Yeah.
And then what they do is they pull out the manga. They like, hand her a copy of the manga. And she just, like, flips through the whole series, sees the shit that this guy has done, and falls in love immediately.
Okay, this is kind of fun.
Because he's the most abnormal of them all.
Oh my god, somebody that's super weird? Yes, please. Like, immediately just...
Well, no, that's her thing. She admires abnormality.
The Vampire Club.
Oh, you guys met?
That's a club that's just for vampires.
Oh, apparently me. I met Amantor, and I don't know when.
I don't know when you met me. But hello.
I have cornered my barbarians at last.
Oh, actually, I might be able to help you then, if you are that close to me. I need...
No, I mean, that whole scene is funny, because the first part's like Rentaro trying to convince Kiki to hang out with him. Mm. And it's like, well, I've got really thick eyebrows. That's not abnormal. A lot of people have those. I've done this and this. A lot of people have done those. And he's like, I've spoken to God face to face.
So did girlfriend
because
number 12.
He has.
Oh, he did.
Yeah, no, he did. He did. And he's like, yeah, I've spoken to God face to face. He did it in episode 1 of the anime. And she's like, there's people who say that on the internet all the time. I don't believe you. She has a very, like, bad standard for what is abnormal.
No, horse archers!
I have power.
I will say, she did not grab me the minute I saw her like some of the other girlfriends. Mm-hmm. But she's grown on me. Oh, hold on. Gandhi has sent me a message.
Do
okay,
you
Gandhi's
like
mad
non?
at me. Gandhi's mad at me.
How did you fuck with Gandhi?
Yeah,
I trained military people. I trained military to defend myself against the barbarians, and apparently Gandhi's just like, no, you cannot do that.
Oh yeah, Gandhi's a real bitch scared. About that.
Oh, yeah. Oh, so it's okay for him?
Yeah, he can do it. You can.
Oh yeah, he's a hypocrite.
That's how it works. Yeah, extreme hypocrite.
Fucking asshole, Gandhi.
Goddamn fucking Gandhi.
Oh, yeah, you know the other anime I've been watching this season?
Which one?
Dekabako, Majo no Oyako, Family Circumstances of the Witch. It's just a cute slice of life, and I feel so bad that it's in this season with, like, so many heavy hitters, because it's gonna get, like, drowned.
I mean, yeah, some shows that I'm watching I quite enjoy, and even though I'm not watching other shows, I can be like, yeah, it's fair, it's not in the top 15.
No, I like it, it's one of my favorites, but it's like, I know a lot of people are not going to watch it because, you know, there's we're in a heated.
Let's see. Off the top of my head, of things I'm not watching right now that will definitely have people watching. Rising of the Shield Hero Season 3. The Apocrypha Fairy Diaries is getting a lot of buzz. Frayrin. Undead Unluck
is definitely the one I'm super heavy into. Like, I can't wait till more of it drops.
So the only reason really I'm not watching it weekly, the only reason I'm not watching it weekly is I'm reading the manga. So I'm gonna binge, like Frayrin, I'm gonna binge it afterwards.
Well, it's honestly kind of fun to watch or to like read the manga for me and then watch the anime, because I kind of like seeing all the different changes. Like with the 100 Girlfriends one, I really like that, and because I do my reviews and stuff on them every week.
Yeah.
I really like just going in and watching all the ways that they're like, oh, hey, this is cool. You're doing, like, this is how they're doing this scene. Or, oh, look, this character wasn't in the anime, like, wasn't in the series yet, but they were retroactively added to the main character's homeroom, and you've snuck them in this scene of the homeroom. Nice. That sort of thing.
Yeah, I'm getting that feeling through Spy X Family.
That they're kind of teasing that? Oh,
no,
stuff.
No, just the little differences.
Yeah. And I like seeing the, like, anime-exclusive stuff.
Yeah. Problem is, a lot of it I've read so long ago, I'm like, is this in the manga, or was this anime original? Because except for the big arcs, I don't really remember.
Chariots are gonna get smashed by that guy. I swear, the barbarians always put spearmen guarding their encampments on purpose.
I mean, that makes sense. Oh shit! I got two back to back.
Barbarians?
Great people.
Oh shit! Oh, nice. Shoot.
Nice. I've only gotten one so far.
Yeah.
Omar Kayon.
What is he?
Scientist.
Oh, nice.
What do you do?
I would love to get great stuff.
Nice.
Eureka!
Nice. Eureka!
And now Coleus?
Coleus.
There's still one country I haven't met yet. It's strange.
I heard they just started the dub of 100 DFs too. I'm not sure if I want to watch it or not, because I've been doing the whole thing in the subs.
But aren't you curious on what each waifu sounds like in English?
Yeah, I don't know. I like both subs and dubs, because I think there's some really good dubs. Mm-hmm. But I don't know. Some of them I just really want to watch the subs.
Okay, it's like a hit and a miss.
Yeah. Definitely. Like, I think some dubs are great. I actually, you know, when I was watching the Girls in Panzer dub, like, I want to like it, but I just can't. I like it, but just not as much. You feel me?
Yeah.
It's like,
yeah.
I really feel like you could have done better.
It's so bad, but I don't have enough money. Andy is too.
Like, the problem I had with that was, was it's just very robotic, a lot of the things sound like. And I don't know why, it bugs me when that happens.
Ooh, I'm being attacked by barbarians! Ah!
Not the barbs.
Oh, the barbs are coming at me again.
Hey, I already did my fight with the barbs.
They come and go.
Barba, 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 hey, Chameleon. What the fuck? How did they get a man at arms?
Right? I got horses at my doorstep.
Crossbows. I have a 48 power man at arms, dude.
I had crossbows.
Yeah, I was trying to get crossbows, but I didn't.
I'm going to have to go straight for guns now, aren't I? Wait, did you turn off score victory?
Yes.
Okay. Like, this single guy is an army.
University. You son of a bitch.
What?
You just completed a wonder, didn't you?
Yeah, I did fetch
you. You son of a bitch. Do you want to guess how close I was?
One turn.
One fucking turn!
I don't know, maybe you should start building your wonders better. I don't know what to tell you. I'm sorry.
Maybe you should suck beep.
Suck these beep. It's like, I'm kind of just going for wonders as they appear on my list. Like, what's valuable?
Well, I'm sorry. I'm also trying to make sure...
You have a list of what's valuable?
It's like, if I'm able to build a wonder, like, if my production value is any less than 10, I'm building a wonder.
Well, I'm sorry. I'm also trying to make sure my people have aqueducts so they don't poop in the river.
I'm panicking about this man-at-arms.
That's a fair thing to panic about.
That's a very fair thing to panic about. 17 turns for a university.
What do I do here?
So I'm going to make a market instead. I gotta send this.
Let's send this guy over here.
Go help. Gandhi sent you a message.
Hey, bitch. You up?
Hello, bitch. Are you up?
Having a weapon is very different from actually using it.
See, Gandhi sent me the same thing. He's mad.
Oh, hey. Mad.
I just met Nzinga.
He's just telling you, hey, cool, you have an army, but don't use it for evil, basically.
Okay, fair enough. Fair enough, Gandhi. I agree with you. I agree with you, Gandingo.
Okay.
Gandingo.
Nut luck of the sea? Are you fucking serious?
King Gandingo. Gandingo.
Nut luck of the sea. Seaman. Come on, yes. Did you let your chat choose?
Maybe. Yes. All of my places are named after something that comes out of males specifically.
No.
Maybe just a little bit.
Yay! Jesus sound. Suck it, Reba. Suck it, Vera. I got one over you.
What did you build? What did you build?
I forgot. What did I build? Apadana.
Oh, that's cool. I've been looking at that one, but I'm like, I don't know. Is that the envoy one?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, that makes sense.
Yeah, it's the one that gives you the envoys when you build wonders in that city.
Oh.
Which I probably should have done earlier since that's in my capital, but whatever.
Yeah, I should have done that too. It is what it is. I need to get to 500 gold.
Why do you need 500 gold?
So it's a fun number. And that too. It's a very fun number. Big numbers make my eyes happy. I have the guild specific. How close am I to that? I need two markets, but not bad.
Oh, Mogadishu. No, not you, actually.
I need one more settler, maybe right here, so I can connect my cities. Choose a new civic.
Oh, that sounds good.
Commercial hub bonuses.
I'm trying to...
Theater square bonuses.
I probably went about this wrong. Oh well.
Eight land units in your military.
Be right back.
I'm seeing how I'm going about this wrong, but it's just like, okay.
Okay, so I've met everyone. We have Victoria and Gandhi.
Victoria?
Ooh. Oh, no, not my bad. Catherine de' Medici. Black Queen version.
Oh, de' Medici. I like de' Medici. It's nice. He's a nice lady. Have the guild civic build a... Do I not have a lumber? No. Is it water? Lumber mill is a thing? Shipyard? Do you know where that is?
No.
Hold up. I ate new 100 girlfriends chapter literally just dropped. Gonna be reading this in the background.
Okay.
Okay. Where is it? Lumber mill. Where and how does one make one of those?
No, actually, fuck that.
That's gonna bother me. I know.
Ungo district.
Let's go here.
I should use stuff. Oh, someone's helping me. Who is that? Oh, India is actually backing me up on this.
Indian does not like barbarians themselves.
Good, good. Let's use that.
Get ready. The Rhine ride will be done in 5 turns. So should I do... That's... What is that? That's a... Shop, industrial zone, aqueduct, water. The water mill is a thing, but not a lumber mill. I'm very confused on where that is.
Ah, fuck me.
What happened?
I just saw my stream, and Fuji Active decided to fuck up.
No, how so?
Like, well,
did it just let?
We're all circles.
Oh, India did it. They knocked out the India knocked out the camp, and I suicide charged the barbarian.
Hey!
I suicide charged the man-at-arms, so all's good in the hood.
Let's build this. Yeah, let's build the industrial zone right there. A lot of my districts only take 4 turns to make.
I should probably make another city or two just to do something.
Yeah, to manage around, right? Melee gunpowder. I finally have my first 10 city. Feels good.
Okay. Oh, I'm about to have mine.
Why? This is annoying.
Boost through great scientist. Oh, where is it? Open technology. Dang, you're really getting there in science, Congo.
I have only one more science than you do.
But, like, you have more, you're ahead in terms of era.
Well, yeah, because I bum-rushed something. Actually, no, Nubia's leading in science. Oh, I am Nubia.
Yeah, you're Nubia.
Well, why does it say Nub? No, I'm not Nubia, you're Nubia. I'm Congo.
One of you is Nubia. Okay.
Yeah, you're okay, so Nubia, Myra.
Well, the real Nubia, please stand up.
I'm Bingo Bango Bongo.
I don't. It says you're ahead of me. That's why.
No, for me it says you're ahead.
It's so very conflicting. I don't know anymore.
By the way, sorry guys. I had to take a second to clean my screen.
Hey, y'all good? Y'all good in the hood? So that'll take 4 turns, and then can I go straight to this? Oh, I can go straight to that. Well, then, let me do that, then.
Uh-oh, what's going on?
He's thinking. Kill him.
You can't use their brain. That's not allowed.
Okay. Don't kill me.
This looks good.
It's nothing to kill you. I'm being very passive.
I really like how I did not plan this, but it goes Perry and Simon, like, small, Vera, medium, and then me, large.
Are you trying to say something?
Yeah, I'm not really good at sizing. And I'm leaving it because it's funny.
I'm not very good at sizing either, don't worry. Oh, maybe on two different ones.
What did I get? Oh, I got some nice great scientists. Hello, boys. What does he do?
Ah, I see your scout is over here. Hello, Congo.
Oh, my scout?
Yeah, I see your scout's over here.
He's probably just hanging out. I set him to automated.
Yeah, he's just vibing.
Rumor has it that Egypt has progressed.
Ah, cool. Jerusalem got a man-at-arms.
Oh, shit.
Get this warrior over there. Oh, now the barbs want to run away from me.
Ah, okay. Fuck me. I found your barbarian man at arms problem.
Oh, yeah, you saw those too?
Right at my doorstep.
Provides 2 housing and 1 amenities. Cool, I finally got my second great scientist. That's what we like to see. University or an encampment? I need more production, though. Cool. I got exactly what I wanted.
What?
I was like, I need more production. Build something that instantly gives me more production. I need a watermelon. Harbor.
You know, now that I think about it, I should probably change my civics. I haven't done that in ages.
Never hurts.
It really doesn't. Ooh, ah, that warrior's trying to run away from me. Can't let any barbarians run free. Gandhi, right. Why are you giving me these terrible trades, man?
I would like to make a deal.
Ah, oh, fuck me!
Not without a date first.
First of all, why not? But second of all...
we have to be a date first.
First of all.
Second of all, I got two men-at-arm barbarians.
Mickey Mouse? First of all,
it's the Mickey Mouse Clubhouse.
Mickey Mouse, huh? We'll play Civilization.
play Civilization.
You thought I couldn't do Dracula forever. I can't do Mickey Mouse forever.
I wouldn't put you through that.
It is all Mickey Mouse, huh?
Must be no suitable location for this game. One more turn, and then I think I can build that. Renaissance Ancient Wonders. Production towards settlers. I haven't made a settler in a minute, so that's useless.
Fuck. I can't levy the military. Why can't I levy the military?
Are you the Caesar?
I should be.
Double check.
Yeah, I am the suzerain.
Do you have enough mullahs?
No.
Oh, that's probably why. Make a deal. What would you give me? Three for one chocolate every time. Joint war. Nah, I don't want to go to war. Chocolate for 63. Never mind. I'll wait till you have more money. Sorry, Gandhi. You're kind of broke. Defenses. Military Academy. Factory. Have the Enlightenment Civic.
Oh, Gandhi's dissing me now. He's dissing me. This.
Oh, that's rude of Gandhi.
I have to train my troops again then. Fine, I see how it is, Gandhi.
Rally the troops. We will fight Gandhi at dawn.
Okay, I need to do something here. Worse off than me.
Don't need that quite yet, so let's do that. Let's skip to that, because I need that wonder done very soon. Cool. My area is expanding. My only issues at the moment is I don't have access to Niter at all. 37 from Nutluck, Honda, Malan. So I need more input. I'm trying to have smart people. And the game won't let me be intelligent.
This is not gonna work.
Peoples. Oh, it was waiting on me, my bad. I do have Niter somewhere. Oh my god. I thought I didn't have no gunpowder. I was gonna cry if I didn't. Random question for you two.
Okay.
Right. If you had to pick a favorite horror movie villain, who would it be?
Oh god, that's a tricky one.
Or at least give me two.
Alright. I kinda like Jigsaw.
Jigsaw's fun.
Just cause I love the weirdness and the like staying out of things. But I also really like Art the Clown from the Terrifier movies.
Ooh, yes.
He's just so out there. You can't help but love him even though you know he's horrible.
Yes, and he probably
so the way he goes about it, the way he moves is so weird.
It's so creative and it's so like his kills are over the top, but creatively over the top. And yeah. You know, call me crazy, but a little funny. A little bit funny. What about you, Wolf?
I mean, I didn't want to go classic, but, like, there is something really interesting about Jason and his whole, like, how he does kill and how, like, he has, like, certain rules where it's like, I can't do this because of this.
Yeah, like he's being he's abiding by his own standards that he sets.
He is a
gentleman of his own game.
He is a unmovable force, but because of his rules, there might be a way around him. I also like Sam.
Who?
He's from Trick or Treat.
Oh, okay.
Now my favorite like stupid horror movie thing. Have you ever seen Rock and Roll Nightmare? It's a personal favorite bad movie of mine.
No.
So it's about this band, this like metal band, that goes to a haunted house to record. Goes to an abandoned house to record. They get ambushed by a bunch of ghosts and scary stuff. And that's basic shit. But the real like absolutely gold in that is that at the end of the movie, you know, it's just the villain and or it's just like the girl and the guy. The girl reveals that she is Satan. Like literally Satan. And the guy and he like set this trap for specifically these musicians.
Yes.
But the guy reveals that he's known this whole time that he's an archangel and he's here to defeat Satan. And that all the other people in the house were illusions made by the archangel. They didn't exist. Which is really weird because there were scenes of people having sex and it's like, what did you do?
I had sex!
Or you know, like there was a scene where he was smooching on one of the girls with his, in the shower. And it's like, did you do that to yourself? Were you like rubbing yourself? But, so he turns into like this big angel and starts, for lack of a better term, oil wrestling Satan.
Oh, that's always fun.
And he turns into like, you know, the scary rotating arm thing. Mm-hmm. But, and the guy is just straight up wrestling him. Mm. And in the background, it's playing like, but it's playing rock. And it's going like, we accept the challenge. It's the best fucking thing I've ever seen.
I changed my answer. Best horror villain, Destiny in Final Destination, Circumstance, Rue Goldberg.
Okay, fair enough. Like
a random stapler.
No, best villain is Beelzebub. From Rock and Roll Nightmare.
Best villain is the fear of the unknown from every horror movie.
Best villain, Ginger Dead Man.
Oh fuck!
Fair enough. But no, it's. I was watching seen the movie on a Riff Tracks.
Congo. Wait, what
did I do? What did I do?
You're right on my border.
Oh my god, I'm sorry, I didn't see that. That was just the only place that was open to found near me. Sorry about that. Won't happen again.
You know what, it's all good, I trust you. You seem like a nice fellow.
I'm not gonna attack you, but please don't attack me either.
I won't. No worries. We can share these waters. It'll be easier to trade with you anyway.
But I first heard it on a Riff Tracks. I'd first seen it on a Riff Tracks Halloween. And they were talking about, like, the frequent viewers were like, everyone get ready to accept the challenge. And I'm like, what the hell is the challenge? And everyone's like, the challenge is coming. You gotta be ready to accept the challenge. And I'm like, what is the challenge? And then that fucking thing hits, and it's just like, I accept the challenge. I accept the challenge.
I've heard
accept
the challenge.
We accept the challenge. It's so good.
Oh, you sons of bitches. Oh, I'm just looking at my envoys and someone took away my suzerain. Suzerain? Suzerain.
Suzerain.
Just like you gotta accept the challenge. What kind of person are you if you can't accept the challenge?
You think after eating 5 slices of pizza, I should stop. But my body's like, nah, you can eat more. Me with stuffed crust pizza.
It's God, I still can't fucking get over we accept the challenge.
We accept.
No, it has to be the, like, you have to do it in the rock thing. Like, we accept the challenge.
Oh, by the way, sorry guys, if France flexes with you, I gave them Mercury for 30 turns.
Oh boy.
I needed money.
And they were like, we have the money if you have the bioweapons.
Yes. And ironically, they didn't want to be friends.
Of course not, they're French.
Yeah, I don't know why you trusted the French.
Why would you think they would want to be friends?
Well, none of you had money.
I have money. I'm just now, giving it to you.
No, yeah. I looked at the money you had, like a couple of turns ago. One of you had 9.
Yeah, that was probably me. Because I bought something that was like 100 bucks.
Yeah, I had to stop the Wonder game because Barbarian Pikeman came at me.
Ah, good, good. Leave them to me.
No, fuck you.
Leave them to Gorgo.
You know what? Let's look at the map. How are you guys doing? Let's see. We got... Yeah, we still got Nubia... Oh, wait, no. That's not what I'm looking for. Let's see. Oh, we got Mabanza Congo. Cool. Vampire
yeah,
Club.
Yeah, name pending. That's name pending. These are all name pending. I just realized I haven't named things in a while, so let me fix that.
Well, it's right next to the Nutluck of the Sea.
I'd stuff your crust plus that beam.
Semen XP levels are at 11.
What about stuffing my crust?
Well, if you are going to, you should do it in Kumlontic.
Yes, that is the best place to do it. Or maybe in Nutluck. Ooh, I have enough money for this now. Stop building that. Start building this.
I do still wish there was an auto build on this.
You said Nutlick? No, I said not luck. But Nutlick's a good name too.
And I'm over here with Foo Fighters, Paramore, Sarset, and Pup. All great bands. I'm kind of trying to, I'm trying to, you know, kind of absorb Jerusalem by building around them.
As you should. Stock point C, chance man. And then C4, stock exchange. Have to save that. I guess I should make a C4 next. The Blood Bank. I get nothing from trading with the Blood Bank.
Don't we all?
Ah, you got that right. Banking. There we go. Ah, I can get more money now! Nice. I mean, licking nuts before eating them is clearly the best way of savoring them. That or just having a fun time.
Those are words.
Those are interesting words to slap together. But agreed? Question?
I'll leave that to your imagination.
That's why I did an emphasis on question.
Ooh. You cultural bitches.
I'm not as culture as freaking Congo. They're going crazy right now.
Oh, fuck. Yeah, no.
What?
You're going crazy for the culture.
No, I'm not. I don't know what you're talking about.
I need to start making builders. That's what I need to do. I haven't been doing builder. Also, tell me, why do we have a big blue and big red, yet not a damn big purple? What do you mean? What do you mean by that?
What do you mean, like the sodas?
Yeah.
I'm surprised you know big blue exists. I'm happy.
I do not know what big blue is.
You ever had big red?
Yeah.
It's the sister soda.
Oh, cool.
Honestly, I like big blue better. But I only know one place where I can get it, and that's at Bucky's. So I have to grab a couple bottles whenever I go down south.
I still need more money.
By the way, I've met the French. I've met the French, if anyone needs to know about them.
Oh, we already know about the French.
Oh, Gandhi was happy with me.
Ah, Mogadishu is into Hinduism.
Instantly built a university and library in this district.
Ooh.
Stop that.
Never.
Wait, what's going on?
He's building another wonder.
Oh, no. Not another wonder.
I said university.
Who would ever build another wonder?
I mean, give me time, I will.
Not if I do first.
Well, right now I'm trying to build up my my bank. Because I need money. Yeah, I'm hurting for money.
I'm working on my troops over here.
Oh, I don't.
No, I'm not going to attack anyone. Okay. I'm just, it's self-defense.
It's for looking.
Hearing that scares me a little bit.
It's just for defense, I promise.
Okay, I will trust you. I will trust you.
You can trust Dracula. Blah. If you can't trust Dracula, who can you trust?
Blah, blah, blah.
I can't believe I didn't trust Count Dracula.
No, you're right.
I just now realized I may have way too many of a certain thing.
I might. Oh, I only have a canvas. What? Oh, motherfucker. Who did Forbidden City?
I haven't.
Wasn't me.
It was one of you. It was probably.
You know there's also the French and the Indians.
Yeah.
Yeah, I forgot about the French and the Indians.
We all know Gandhi likes doing forbidden stuff.
Like foreplay.
Foreplay's forbidden? Shit.
I mean, if you're Mormon.
I mean, I can instantly make... I can instantly create a wonder if I wanted to. There's just nowhere for me to put them.
I mean, you could, but you shouldn't.
Awards two iron. Rewards forfeit to all your cities. None of these wonders are good. Commercial hub. I guess I'll just make it commercial hub. No big deal.
Francis found Catholics.
No! They'll do terrible things to the natives.
Government. I haven't changed my government in so long. And I got monarchy a long time ago.
This is.
I changed it. Let's see. Industrial zones, holy site. Each city receives one for each nationality or district. Let's do this one. This one's nice. Get a bonus. Ooh, I jumped in science now. Good.
Oh, yeah, nice.
Very good. Thank you. Let's get my builder over there. Thank you.
France is now trading with India.
No!
I'm just giving you the heads up.
No, I appreciate it. I forget to look up the little info thing.
Damn.
Well, I mean, last time you guys... I don't like sharing it, because last time you guys accused me of using spies for it.
Well, that was just for fun.
That was mere jest.
Let me see. How do I look up information again? I forget.
Maybe I should have put that great person over there. I may have done a dumb. This is way worse than YouTube, and they're like unskippable. What? Oh yeah, sometimes you'll get like really short ads, and they might be a little bit. But I mean, hey.
Rumor has it that the Congo has progressed from the Renaissance era to the Industrial era.
Have I? I'm just researching shit.
Rumor has it that Nubia has progressed from the medieval to the Renaissance.
Am I that much behind? Jesus.
Actually, you've got the most science of all of us right now.
Cleopatra doesn't know.
You're the furthest. You're way farther than me. Again?
I literally just rushed, technology. I just rushed scientific theory. That's all I did.
Yeah, that's still way further. Super far. Like, I'm doing scientific theory now.
Any consolation, I have a long way to go before I get more technology. I have to go back to get sailing.
Oh. That's fair.
Repeat that route. Are we talking about science?
Yeah. Yes.
I mean, right now, Nubian Empires has the most science per turn.
Yeah, yes. That's what I was saying.
Yeah, but you're not Nubian, are you? Yeah, you're Nzinga.
No, I'm not Nubian. I'm Congo.
Yeah, so I don't know what he's talking about.
No, in terms of, like, research.
Oh, fair.
He's the furthest. Yeah.
Yeah, fair. Oh, I'm actually not doing terrible in Taurus. Not doing great, but I'm not doing terrible.
I need a military engineer. That would be really good right now. But what another city? That too. Choose research.
Who do I got? Ooh, Raja Todar Mal.
Who's that?
No idea.
I mean, what kind of great person?
Oh, he's a merchant.
Oh, nice.
Born in Uttar Pradesh to a Hindu family. That's about all is known of the young Todar Mal. Okay.
Okay, so it's not yours?
Oh, he's recruited.
Oh, I thought you had him.
Well, I do now.
Three workshops. Home harbor, three workshops. So that's what I'm going to have to work on. Next. So let me stop this production. Oh, I can't. Why can't I make more of that? Gold in every stock exchange. Gold in every bank. I'm gonna just get that bonus. 40 turns until I make that. Yikes. That's so long. I don't want to wait 40 turns. Who has the time for that?
I mean, I'm spending 15 to make a harbor.
That's so costly.
Let's see. So what do I do with all this? Okay, there we go.
I mean, it'll help a lot.
Why can I not build a farm? This is like blank ass territory. Oh well.
Maybe it wants it to be put on like a specific tile.
There's another builder, and we're good.
Oh my god, I think I might have to do this. Can I ask for a truce?
Between who and who?
Both of you.
Sure.
Sure.
No, here's the truce. I want to build Angkor Wat, and it's going to take me 50 turns.
I'm not going to build Angkor Wat. Go ahead.
Yeah, I have no intention of building that. Go for it. Well, you want to spend 50 turns on
it? Yeah, now that I say that out loud, I'm like, shit, no.
Are you sure? I mean, if you commit to it, I will not mess with you.
I don't think I have the resources to give up one of my cities for 50 turns.
Yeah, that is the kicker.
Fuck it.
I mean, if you build Angkor Wat, if you let me build Oxford, then you can build that.
Nope. What? Because I have a feeling Oxford is like, what, 28?
No, yeah. It's 40. It's 44 for me.
Oh. Okay, yeah.
Yeah.
Wow, okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's why I offered that.
Only if Perry agrees to build his biggest wonder. We all just sacrifice a city.
Well, let me figure out what that is first. My biggest right now is 15 turns. Actually, no, it's about 20 turns. Never mind.
Oh, damn.
Give it 22 because I have to finish another building first before I can do that. Actually, let me see what happens in the next couple turns. So we'll see what happens.
Oh, never mind. I can build Angkor Wat for 18.
Okay. How'd you get that sudden boost?
The first city I looked at was it was my second biggest. My capital is at 13.
Mm.
Okay. So yeah, you can build Oxford, I'll build Angkor Wat, and he'll build whatever he has.
Might not build Oxford. It's still 44 turns regardless. Well, I don't think I can.
My capital
I will not
save it for me later, then.
You have my word. I will not cockblock you if you decide to build it right now.
I am building Angkor Wat.
Thank you.
I am waiting for my commercial hub to finish, but then I'm going to start building my wonder. So we will all sacrifice a city.
Yep. I'm sacrificing my capital.
I am sacrificing the Vampire Club.
No, wait. You don't like them.
Well, yes, that's exactly why.
Yeah.
But they do good work. They do good work.
You know what? I'll be nice. Paramore is building a entertainment complex because all my places are terrible for amenities.
Yours too.
Yeah. Starset is building a library, and Pup has been building a harbor for 15 turns.
Okay, I am working on a wonder. It is not one of the ones you were talking about in Transylvania. And everything else is just kind of doing its own thing.
Okay, cool.
So I will I'm also going to lock down one of my smaller cities because it's got to build a museum.
No suitable. Excellent, Vera. Now you've acquired the foreign goods and troops from the east. You can conquer the village to the west. Why would you say something like that?
Excuse me? What was that about conquering?
I'm not conquering. I don't even have any military.
I was going to say, we had a deal here, guys. We're not going to mess with each other.
Anything even really worth working on besides city walls, which I have not even touched? I mean, I could get a builder done, but that's actually what I might do. I might start sending a builder there to boost production, because I can't. I literally cannot do anything else.
Okay, as our agreement is, I have laid down my arms. I have set up all my troops to do my building.
Cool.
Or not, you know what I mean? I started the wonder.
Yeah.
Turns
out Gandhi in France is just about to go to war with all of us.
Oh, they can go to war with us. They can go to war with all of us. We can smash them. We can wreck them.
We could jump them. We can definitely jump them. What is Oxford? Oxford is still 41. I'm trying to.
Is that with your capital?
Nah, my capital is not able to build it. That's the issue. It won't let me. Yeah, sucks. Oh, there's a horseman just kind of chilling outside.
So when remind me, when do you get to change your government and civics and stuff?
Whenever you get a new policy.
Okay. France is now monarchy, by the way, in case y'all wanted to know.
This is interesting. Barbarian pikemen really up my ass.
Is there a tile I can get a deduction? Because golly, that's what I need. Population of 10 or greater. Oh, there we go. I can build a workshop. Let's go. After 5 turns.
I'm gonna hold off.
I'm gonna be doing nothing for the next few turns.
Same.
Okay, let's.
Let's see. What can I do in semen?
I don't know. What can you do in semen?
Oh. I have options. Now I can make Oxford. Thank you. In 18 turns. Rika for 2 random technologies. Okay, now they have a use.
I just saw a very interesting YouTube title.
Mm-hmm.
Lucky Star, the anime no one remembers.
Oh, I remember. But that's because I was a part of the convention scene.
Gandhi, fuck off. Gandhi just tried to steal my great work. He's like, I'm going to give you 5 gold per turn in exchange for your great book.
Lame Gandhi.
Yeah.
Hell no.
All right, Gandhi. Yeah, I wouldn't take that either.
I will say, I did I gave Gandhi open borders for $3.
$3. You sold your soul for $3.
I mean, I sold, you know, the rights to walk through my fields.
Yeah, he's gonna walk all over you now.
I'm not even.
He's gonna be like,
I'm not even near Gandhi. That's the funny thing. Oh shit, gunpowder. I have a funny feeling I'm gonna need gunpowder.
Hold on, I should change my government.
Who? Ooh, industrial era.
Okay, change government.
Do I like Darwin?
Darwin's but I can okay. change policies. Okay, change policies. We'll do this one because I like that one. And we'll do this one because I like that one. Then we'll those are fine.
So Chancellor, I'm gonna have to transfer them back to Seaman. Go back to Seaman.
Go back to Seaman.
Go back to becoming Seaman.
Return to Seaman.
Not as good as the sequel.
Return to Monkey.
How many cities are you guys at?
I'm at 6, I think.
Oh, I'm sorry. Angkor Wat is not a natural wonder? Fuck me.
I told you I'm not building Angkor Wat.
No. I just got a great person, and his thing is he has to be next to a natural wonder. And Angkor Wat apparently is not natural.
Reject humanity. Become Seaman. Yes. Become Seaman.
Return to Seaman.
Return to Seaman.
Lil Spurn.
Lil Spurn. Oh. Complete a the National Park Museum. I definitely need better culture at the moment. That's my downfall. So Vera, don't worry. Your semen always has a place for me. You know it.
That's what I was trying to do.
So where the hell was the... oh, there it is. There's the culture I was trying to do.
I just have Charles Darwin sleeping in a temple.
Ain't that ironic, am I right?
Yeah.
Oh, this should be helpful.
It's not that bad. How much of a purchase a seller a year? 340, just about the same.
Oh, good. Another one of these people.
One of you people.
What do you mean by you people?
I keep getting a bunch of, like, a certain great person, and I don't have anything to do with them.
Oh, I can do a Merchant Republic. I mean, you know what?
Like, there's...
Yeah, let's go for it. Merchant Republic.
I just learned about that from the news. Congratulations.
Oh, congratulations. Fourteen turns until this is finished. Let's go. Make Cumlantic great again.
You just now realize Gandhi wants to send a delegation. Come, Gandhi. Come on. You know, I just now noticed Gandhi's been in both of our games so far.
Huh. Yeah.
Which is odd.
Gandhi was also in the game I did off-screen.
He likes showing up.
I'm telling you, he's the real Civ 6. The real civilization mascot.
I'm a great merchant. Let's go.
I about industrial zone?
You said you were making Angkor Wat, right?
Correct.
Okay. Because Angkor Wat just popped up for like 9 turns.
For you?
Yeah, for me.
Oh.
You got that.
Yeah.
I need something more important.
Also, we would hit it at the same time. So I don't know. I don't know how that would work.
Me neither. Makes me a little curious, but I'm not playing around with that.
You know what?
I see barbarians. I see barbarians, folks.
Oh, we made a deal. I'm a man of my word. Don't worry.
Oh, I've been seeing barbarians this whole time. Hence why I'm like one of the strongest armies. Oh, no. Nazinga took me over.
Well, I've had a very strong army for a while.
Well, I didn't look for a while.
Good thing sucking is my pleasure. Sucks to suck. I need that.
Nobody expects the Congo.
Yeah. First, find it on a map. Bombo.
Ow.
Oh, I got so much culture out of that. Oh my god.
Out of what?
So I built the. I have a lot of rainforests in my area, right?
Oh yeah, that would do it.
Yeah,
that would
So Chichen Itza, once that monument was built, it put 2 purple in every single piece of rainforest.
Wow.
That's big.
Oh, you want an embassy? Yeah, come on. Well, you got to do the same to me though.
Yeah, your embassy is welcome. Welcome to Seaman.
Pleasure to be here.
Oh, it's a pleasure for everyone to be here. That's kind of how it is. It's kind of how we roll. Get that. Have a neighborhood.
Ooh, that sounds fun.
So let me get mercantilism done.
Oh, I'm in a monarchy right now.
Damn.
I'm in something else.
I'm the Kingo of the Congo.
Merchant Republic. Very money and route forward. Doesn't really help me for endgame.
I am the king. Got like the, I got the Bugs Bunny King thing going on. I don't need these people. Stop giving me these people.
Who are you people?
You know, really, I don't need these people. They don't work with my strategy. But they're just here. Okay, yeah. I'm gonna start taking the fight to the barbs up here.
I mean, I'm not fighting them, but I did just prioritize gunpowder.
Oh yeah, no, I've got guns blazing already.
For gunpowder, you need what? Coal?
Niter.
Yeah, I haven't found niter.
I have, I just haven't bothered touching it.
What does niter look like again?
Oh, I just got a message from the Black Queen.
It looks like black and red gunpowder.
Okay, the Black Queen likes me. France likes me.
I found a lot of fucking mercury.
France apparently likes me because I have guns.
That sounds like France. Oh, you can kill us? We surrender. Tell me I'm wrong, yeah, French people. Oh, found niter.
There's
a lot of niter. Well, too bad it's out of my area.
I remember seeing the, what was it? There's this guy who's been dubbing over Gen 1 My Little Pony clips. There's one where it's like ponies versus the French. So, you know, they dispose of the evil king and the good king takes his place. He's like, well done, ponies. I will honor my word. I surrender. It's like, no, you don't do that anymore. We want you on the throne. Like, sorry, it's a force of habit.
It's something I am used
it's
to.
It's a force of habit. I surrender. No, you don't do that anymore.
Okay, so you don't want me to bend over.
It's like, no, that's not... Why would you think such a thing?
I mean, you know what? Yes.
Saint Mitchell Builder. We've got 11 turns.
Now, there is, unfortunately, troops that are pillaging my territory.
Your military might is getting there, Zira. Thank you for noticing.
By the way, I hope y'all don't mind if I take some more city-states.
Are you taking city-states?
Well, not military, but I'm, you know, got a bunch of envoys, so I figured I may as well unload them.
Just don't take, Bandar Bruni.
I have no idea where that is, so it's safe.
None of these production with an armory, every city with an army. Oh, I might need to start making some armory soon. I didn't notice how good they.
Oh, you took a bonus. Oh, you took the suzerain position from Nanmadol from me.
Oh, sorry.
It's all good.
Do what you got to do.
I will have him back.
Okay, go ahead.
To be fair, he's not actually the one I want to fight the most with. The one I want the most is Mogadishu.
I don't think I have access to Mogadishu, so...
I don't think I have it either.
Oh no, I do have access to Mogadishu.
Oh, I do have access to Mogadishu too.
Well, they're currency. Get the fuck away.
Yeah, that's kind of what I'm rolling with. I'm like the richest one right now. Oh my god.
Yeah, no, you're swimming in the dough.
Alright. I have nothing to buy. It's my dilemma. Ooh, that might change immediately. Let me... That's 700 about to go down the drain? No, that's 610. Nah, I'll wait. I honestly should buy a settler, though. So I'm gonna upgrade you to a crossbowman. And the settler is literally 3 turns. So I'm not gonna waste money on that. And I'll just be patient. I should make a fifth city, though, because I only have 4. I've been kind of just min-maxing them.
Yeah.
That 167 culture per turn is nuts. Wow.
Oh yeah, that's you may not know this, but I invented the song Bingo Bango Bongo, I don't want to leave the Congo, and it's just a thing here. Like, you can't stop playing it. It plays 24/7.
I understand. It's such a bop.
I haven't actually done anything else in terms of culture other than come up with that song.
You might win via the culture game.
You know, I find it funny. I say, like, I want to be suzerain on Mogadishu. It went up. Huh, funny.
How do you get a lot of tourists?
I have no idea. I think it might just be great stuff. Great artists and stuff.
Yeah, because at this rate, you might win again.
So what you're saying is we should kill him.
No. Yes. No, you shouldn't. I don't think you should do that. I think you should do anything but that, honestly.
I don't know. You kind of have a lot of culture. That's not good.
I'm just sitting here being cultured. I'm just sitting here sipping my wine, listening to the same song 30 times.
With also the biggest army.
Yeah, about
dude.
That.
That's insane.
Martrape, did you just pause the game?
No, he won.
Wait, you won?
Yep.
Yeah, that culture... Dude, how did you get in 100 turns? That's insane.
Well, I honestly think I screwed it up because I should have been building art museums instead of archaeology museums. Basically, for some reason, the Congo was really, really good at generating great people. So I just loaded my policy slots up with great people generation, and I got 1 million great writers early in the game. I got 1 million great artists.
How many?
And just had them set them.
How many artists and writers do you need to win by culture?
I think it depends on like the culture itself, like related to other people.
Yeah,
I can understand that, but
I feel like there should be a rough number.
And I kind of beelined. The cultural stuff. So like Oracle plus Congo is really good apparently, because like that's great people generation too. Oracle plus Congo, and then it's like, okay, get the thing that boosts great writers, get a bunch of theater squares.
I think it should honestly stop being peaceful.
No.
Because every time you're left alone, you kind of just like go off. When you're on your own devices.
You've discovered... I'll be honest, this was a complete accident.
Oh, fuck. Oh, I'm looking at the graphs, and player gold... Mordrip just goes off the screen.
Oh, yeah. I had, like, 1,000 just sitting in there. I didn't expect... Culture is usually the hardest thing to get, but you got that, like, way too fast.
No, I'm telling you, I realize, because what I think you're supposed to do with Congo is you're supposed to use the archaeology bonuses, because they get good bonuses from archaeology. But I had 1 million great artists and nothing, like, nowhere to put them. So there's, like, 6 great artists just hanging out in my base.
Are you guys looking at the graphs as well?
Yeah.
Oh, I was looking at the board. But my plan was to go for culture.
I didn't realize
how I was doing it.
Yeah, you're great.
Hey,
great people have a lot of passives.
Because, like, I wasn't doing the best on money or science or anything. It was literally just bum-rushing great people.
I just want to show this graph off to you guys.
Also, I think the thing is, nobody else was doing culture, right? Because when it comes to tourists, people can kind of
that was the other thing. That was the other thing.
So
I would probably have like had to go way deeper. I was working on getting radio and stuff.
So my main strategy was science. Most of my stuff was technological. Problem is, I kept running out of money, so I also had to be a massive commerce. So I took some time to build that up. And I also kept having barbarians. My route game was great until, your culture kind of took over it.
Until fucking Dracula showed up.
Yeah.
Fucking Dracula.
I'm going to be honest, I was playing the game this entire time.
Blah, blah, blah. But no,
I was trying to go for the science victory too. I had insane science in workshops all over the place.
I just
want to
say, I never researched astrology.
I don't think I did either.
Castles or irrigation.
Oh yeah, so you just skipped so your people were dying and they were just hating you.
Well, they weren't dying. It was just amenities.
I also took some time to clear up amenities.
Because my place was pretty well stocked.
But yeah, I'm looking at the graph of culture. It is insane.
Yeah, nobody else was touching it at all.
Yeah, no, that's kind of why the cultural thing took so long last game, because both Vyra and I were competing for it.
Wow. Mm. The only
Before
people
I shifted over.
The only people that were doing religion was Gandhi and Kaffrin.
Yeah, because they didn't realize we took out religious victory.
Mm-hmm. Okay, yep. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, I am off the map. Player gold. Jesus.
Isn't insane. Science, yeah, for the most part, science, we were all entangled. I lost a little bit at the end because I had to work on commerce, and apparently I should have worked on commerce first and then done science like Mordrip did. But even then, I'm sorry, not Mordrip, Vera. But with that being said, Perry, you're also really up there in science.
Yeah.
Yeah,
you were just dominating.
Moving in between them. Because I was looking at the culture and I'm like, this is relatively big.
You also had the biggest army. For a long time.
I was dealing with barbarians the whole time.
Just across the board, you just, with Congo, you just dominated.
You were just better.
Period.
Okay, I'm afraid to look at great people earned.
Yo, am I a Congo
main? Ah, fuck.
Yeah, you're a Congo main. We absolutely couldn't touch you.
So, Vera,
well,
do you...
Well, I also realize these guys have a surprisingly good, or at least this lady has a surprisingly good bonus, where you get, like, you get plus 10% yields to everything if your city is on the same continent as your capital.
Vera, do you want to guess how many great people Perry earned?
Not really, no. Like, I know he got, like, great works constantly.
Roughly around 30.
Oh, yeah, no.
And
yeah.
Pretty much all of them were writers or artists.
We had no chance.
Yeah,
zero.
No. Like,
zero chance.
It, yeah.
You're left alone too much.
Okay, I'm starting to understand.
Now you know why war is necessary.
Oh,
but
no.
like I'm serious though. I don't know how to play Civ 6, I swear to God.
Okay, Chad, can I get a bullshit? He's won twice.
Can I get a bullshit in the chat?
This is just the Civ 5. This is the Civ 5 experience bleeding in.
Well, that's kind of still more than at least me as far as I'm concerned.
So, I've been streaming for 3.5 hours. We started an hour late. You won in two and a half hours.
Yeah.
Like, we could start a whole nother game.
I am doing a charity stream tomorrow, time. I'm going to take this defeat as a positive and get some sleep.
Bingo, bango, bongo. Simon can't now play the Congo.
You know
bingo,
what?
Bango, bongo, jangle.
You know what?
I'm banned from the Congo, aren't I?
You know what? Next time you play, you should let me and Vera choose your person.
Okay. I'm telling you, I'm gonna bomb it, but I'm okay with that.
So the funny thing is, I don't think me and Vera is gonna choose what we think is the worst. We're just gonna be like, what's funny?
Well, no, I think we should play Congo again. Actually, if you want to.
No, because you guys are gonna gang up on me now because you know that the Congo is a threat.
Yeah, yeah. You see that you have Congo and we have the biggest warmongers.
I mean, well, I could break out an old meme from my Civ 5 days and be the goddamn Zulu.
You could. Well, I'm
no,
like
was, it was specifically the joke was the goddamn Zulu.
The goddamn Zulu. I'm also.
I remember it was like 30 minutes. My friends and I were arguing about people. I was like, "All right, fine. I'm gonna be the goddamn Zulu. I'm gonna pick the goddamn Zulu.
I'm gonna pick the goddamn Zulu."
And so every time it's like, you know what? If no one picks, I'm gonna pick the goddamn Zulu. I'm gonna do it. I've never won a game as the goddamn Zulu.
I'm also like completely out of my element because like my best thing is playing domination civs. Like that's what I'm decently good at. And so doing anything else and being passive is, like, because so like foreign to me that I don't know what to do.
Heads up. I don't know if you're looking at like your stream. Fine. But apparently, Fuji Active had issues with Discord.
It's been fine for me.
Oh, I got a warning. The connection to Discord failed.
About to suck on that mermaid meat. Yo. Hey, yo.
Wow, you gotta
do what you want, because a pirate is free. You are a pirate. Your heart fiddled indeed. Being a pirate is a wretched thing. Do what you want, because a pirate is free. You are a pirate.
Thank you. Oh, thank you, Perry, for following.
Congo Diamonds.
Okay. Yeah. No. Straight up, just got a connection issue. Sorry, guys. You're just going to be looking at a Fuji circle.
I heard that one of the Congo leaders is like the worst character, and the other is pretty good.
You know what? Since we got some time, Google.
The male Congo is the bad one. The woman Congo, I think she might be one of the best.
Okay. I didn't know. I picked Nzinga.
You did that twice. That's the funny thing, without even trying.
What, picking the Congo?
No, picking like what's considered like S tier.
I swear to God, I'm not doing any of this on purpose.
Okay, so
that's what makes it funny.
I literally just pick, like, I look at the abilities, I'm like, I like that. I'm gonna do that.
So Pocket Tactics has a Civ 6 tier list. Let's see what they have.
What the hell is Pocket Tactics?
It's a website.
Okay. Where's Gorgo? Gorgo S tier.
S and A tier leaders: Abraham Lincoln, Alexander the Great, Basil II, Frederick, that guy. Hojo, Tokamune, Montezuma. Oh, I can see that.
She's not on there. The Congo lady's not on there.
Paris Celeste, I'm not done. Peter the Great.
That's a different list.
Queen Sion Dionk. Simon Bolivar, Tragon, Wilfrid Laurier, Amator, Black Queen at Catherine,
Cleopatra. So am I just banned from playing all of those characters?
No. Cleopatra, Cyrus, Eleanor of Aquitaine, Genghis Khan, John Curtin, Coupe, Mafia's Corvinus, Menlik.
Oh, okay, guys. You're looking at a weird list, because like I'm hearing a lot of those, and the lists I see, they're commonly at the bottom.
Well, I don't
I was like, gonna say Catherine, Coupe.
Catherine, Coupe, John Curtin, they're all Coupe, like C.
Coupe seems like really, really... I did look at a couple of like just recommended leaders for different victories, but nothing like tier list-wise.
Yeah, I'll be honest. I don't like he's not really given a reason of why these tiers
are... Something like Coupe, I could see being an S tier on an island map, but nowhere else.
He goes little by little of why he thinks. Okay, so what are the ones that like you're really surprised by?
I don't know. From here, right?
Shaka.
I'm gonna look at like Shaka's, some of the ones where's that Shaka I see Zulu? That's common.
What tier is the goddamn Zulu?
Zulu? Zulu.
I am not seeing them. Gandhi's a D, which I find funny.
Gandhi's D.
Do you still have my on Discord?
I remember Civ 4. Civ 4, Gandhi was OP as shit.
So,
his special unit was just a worker, a fast worker.
Yeah.
But it's amazing how good just a fast worker is.
Yeah.
For here, let me see. Like Lincoln, Coomer, Victoria, Yongle, and Congo are S.
I remember hearing good things about Yongle too.
Yeah,
Yongle is like.
I do not see Zulu on the list.
Big smart man. And A is Basil, Aquitaine, Elizabeth, Babylon, Hojo, the one that I played. Saladin, Mali, and
I can't see Saladin. I really can't. This is why Roger's business is putting Chaney in the spotlight, though.
Saladin. Well, there's two Saladins. One of them is religious, and that's the A.
So let's see what the gamer says.
Mm-hmm. That's the one that I'm looking on.
Top five. Abe, the character you played.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, Abraham Lincoln, Amanitor, Javaya Varman, Victoria, Age of Steam, which, yeah, we talked about that one last time.
Yeah.
Yongle of China.
Mm.
Oh.
Yongle is, like, very sciencey.
So the Congo lady is, like, ridiculous?
She's not even an A.
Bruh.
Really? That's weird. A lot of these lists are very subjective then, because I see a lot in so many different spots.
I guess it also is like a lot of just, you know, maybe he ran into one good player who like stomped him with Yongle and just decided that Yongle was insane because of that.
The only one that I know for sure is insane
found Nzinga.
is Age of Steam.
Nzinga
is
B tier, good. The bulk of Civilization VI leaders fall into this category. They're good. They win games. They just don't have the same wow factor as the S and A tier. I can understand.
Yeah, I can see that.
Also take into account though that all these a lot of these lists, like the one on the gamer especially, is taking into account Gathering Storm and all of that. So they might seem more powerful. Like
I can see that
in normal gameplay, she seems super powerful.
Yeah, to be honest, I've been playing Gathering Storm.
Wow.
I'm not really a big fan.
This person does not like Cleopatra. Both of them are in mediocre.
Yeah, they don't know.
Like, I don't know why. Like I just don't really like...
What about
am I
the
thinking?
Other one? There's Rise and Fall.
Okay, there's an...
But that's just before Gathering Storm.
There's a bottom five F tier. If we remember, we should all choose an F tier.
What's in the F tier? Just screenshot it and we'll know for next time.
Go to Discord. I have it up for you guys.
Well, all right, I'll be the other Congo then.
Catherine D'Amici, Black Queen. Harald Hardrada of Norway. Hardrada. Mvemba Nzinga of the Congo. Tamara, right, Georgia.
Congo time, boys.
Oh, Tamiris.
Horses. Let's go.
Obsifia.
I'm taking Tamiris.
Most important thing, what tier is Gorgo?
Oh, good question.
What tier Gorgo?
You know what? Let's make this easier. Gorgo. Okay, that's great. What tier are you?
What tier Gorgo?
Good.
Gorgo good.
Yeah.
Gorgo good.
Gorgo's good.
Gorgo's good. Also, always good.
Also, like, okay, which artist really wanted to fuck this guy? Like,
Horsecock really good.
Like, okay, like, this guy had, or this person had fun drawing this guy.
Oh, yeah. You know, that's who they likey.
I have no idea who this is, by the way.
I don't know.
Are you Chandra Gupta? You're not Gupta.
Probably Pedro, you know.
What tier is the goddamn Zulu?
Not sure.
Okay, someone had fun writing this. Players were so excited about Tomiris and her Siphian hordes with Civilization VI launched due to her ability to get two cavalry units for the price of one. That didn't turn out to be a powerful enough ability to conquer the world, however, and the feared Siphian queen ended up riding a one-trick pony.
Yeah, she's really... The only thing she's good at is money and horses. That is literally it.
Let's see. Routinely derided as the worst leader in Civ 6, Tamar's benefits are limited to slightly better walls and men-at-arms. She could periodically leverage her religion in city-states to win votes for a diplomatic victory, but she'll be quickly overshadowed by better faith Civs.
Wait, who is this about?
Tamar of Georgia.
Okay, Tamar. What's it say about the Congo lady?
Mvemba Nzinga. While Congo can build some of the biggest cities in the game, motherfucker.
I didn't build any big cities.
An ability
you
to...
had one that was 17.
No, I didn't. It was
yes,
like
you
10.
Did. I was right next to you. It was 17.
I mean, if that's the case, then I'm just being an idiot because I didn't see it, honestly.
Yeah, it was massive.
Okay, this is... I didn't even know that there was a civ that could do this. Nzinga, inability to found a religion, is a major weakness. The addition to Nzinga Manda to the game renders the game's original Congolese leader obsolete.
Isn't he an isn't that like an atheist or just doesn't believe in like false religions?
No, I think it was more that he was just open to religion. Whereas like I didn't make one myself, but I want to see what all you guys did.
Harald Hardrada
Leving. I didn't make a religion either.
Neither did I. Well, I started it. Leving your city-state vassals can turn a war around, and the new version of Harald introduces in Rulers of England can do so very cheaply. It's a fun trick, but relying on an emergency measure as your main strategy isn't the best play. Challenge! I'll fail.
Challenge.
The one that surprised me is Catherine de Medici. Spies are great, but the Black Queen doesn't enhance them enough to make them worth building a strategy around. Play her alternate version, or better yet, Eleanor, for a much better experience playing as France. I mean, I thought Catherine de Medici wasn't that bad. Again, this is Black Queen in particular.
No! Yeah. There's been a flood.
All she can do is really just shoot out spies. That's her, like, her only special ability, and that's why she seems bad, because she doesn't have abilities.
I mean, you can do a lot with spies.
You can, but think about how long it takes till you get spies.
Okay.
Yeah, fair enough.
I will say, if we do the bottom five idea, I will take Tamar of Georgia, because I honestly don't think she's that bad.
I honestly kind of want to do the Congo again and just see how much of a difference there is.
He's a fun-looking guy. I like him.
Yes, he's a cool dude.
And then we got Horse Girl.
Yes, I will reprise my role as Horse Girl.
Horse Girl.
Which, in our first game, for an F-tier character, I did surprisingly well.
Yeah, no, you did really well.
Yeah, but I everything he said, I do understand.
Yeah, no, that makes sense. Go to the people we were playing as last game. Did we get anything about Gorgo? Like, did you read Gorgo's description?
Gorgo didn't have a subscription.
Gorgo no subscribe to YouTube.
No, because B and C are so big, he didn't write anything.
Okay, fair enough.
He wrote about the best ones and the worst ones. Which, I kind of want to look at more of those. Because there's like 50 leaders.
True.
Oh, okay, so... he did write about the guy I played last time.
Mm. Oh?
Japan is one of the most beginner-friendly civilizations in the game. Thanks primarily to the Meiji Restoration ability, encourages smart gameplay by rewarding players for grouping their districts together for adjacent bonuses. The Samurai and Electronics Factory are also excellent reasons to play Japan at any skill. You know what? He's right. If I did that, that would have been really good. I did not... clump my my districts.
Your troops together.
Yeah. This is fun. Oh wait, didn't someone play as Elizabeth?
Yeah, I was I was steampunk Elizabeth.
Oh, this is just normal Elizabeth. Is a fantastic all-around leader thanks to her exceptional economy. If she's lucky enough to be on a naval map, she also ensures that her lands are unassailable with a powerful navy. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
The one that they were playing is Age of Steam. Victoria.
Which is S, by the way.
I swear I did not know.
Production is the single most important thing in the game. Okay.
Well, yeah, I know that.
And the new version of Victoria released in the Rulers of England pack excels at making it. Without production, you can't do much else. But as Victoria proves, if you have an overabundance of production, you don't need much else. As long as she can keep her population growing, Victoria can quickly build anything and everything that she might need. When in doubt, go with the queen. If I remember that game right, you were building at a really quick rate.
Yeah, that was about all I was doing, though.
But
that's all you need. That's all you need to do. That's why when you're left alone, it's a problem.
Gee, okay, I get it. Don't leave me alone. I understand.
Oh, wait.
I'm just going to keep
going. No, I know. I'm joking.
Here's the fun. You see, I'm going to leave you a little bit because Mr. Vera here played Nubia, mm-hmm. who's also in S tier. Mm-hmm. The Queen of Nubia is the best pick for players who like to carefully plan out their cities. Nubian pyramids can rack up incredibly tiled bonuses, which, if I remember right, I don't even have to say you said. I saw the graphs. If the surrounding area is correctly developed, so it's no wonder that Nubia is a common pick. Amator also has built-in defense against early barbarians, thanks to the incredible Pitati Archer. Keeping the peace and building large cities let Amator easily pursue any victory conditions she likes, further solidifying her place among the top five.
I was playing her completely wrong then, because I was not making any of those Nubian pyramids, because I had no deserts.
we should have swapped. I had a lot of desert.
Yeah, like, I had maybe, like, the only desert tile was this, was, like, the three, and that's why I was building wonders. But besides that, I only had deserts in one city, so I was doing nothing. Just nothing. That's sad.
Oh, actually, I see who you should play, just from the first line. There's no leader better at feeding their people than Jaya Varman. There you go. That he'll be great in Comtopia and like Fuckerberg or whatever you called it.
Feed the men.
Yeah.
Feed the men. I like feeding men.
Well.
Oh no, no. I'm thinking of
Well, the Khmer is where you should go.
I just like feeding men. Nothing wrong with that.
Oh no, I was thinking of fucking Cooking with Jack again because I can't get that guy out of my head apparently.
By the way, that was a fun string.
I've seen those. Likewise, yeah.
What, the Cooking with Jacks? You gotta see some of his new stuff. It's fantastic.
I was a part of that marathon, that stream you did.
Oh, yeah. Wait, you were part of the Jack stream?
Well, I came in and said hi, and we talked for a bit.
Oh, yes.
Yes. You unfortunately was doing it while I was at work, so I didn't get to pop in.
It's okay. There'll be another time we can all get together in Jack.
I learned a lot, and I am now sad.
I've made that joke twice now in the last 2 days, one during a Danganronpa stream and one during this, and I don't regret it in the slightest.
Yeah.
You were playing Danganronpa?
Well, my friend was playing. I was mostly just being a sarcastic voice actor for Byakuya.
I mean, that's always the fun part.
That is.
That's about all I can do.
Have you gotten around to Danganronpa 2 yet?
No, I'm not really big into that sort of thing, like those sort of games right now, and my friend only does one stream of it a year.
So would you mind if I spoil you on something?
No, don't spoil me.
Okay.
Also, Danganronpa 2, like, if you don't like 1, I can understand, but 2?
No, 2 is the one we were playing. 2 is the one we were playing.
Oh, then it's not a spoiler. I was going to talk about Fat Byakuya.
Fat boy.
You mean the hamster?
No.
No, Fat Byakuya is in 2.
I didn't know that.
He's the first dead guy.
Oh, I didn't know that. Don't spoil anything. I came in on the second murder.
Oh, it was the one.
Well, that's not really a spoiler.
No.
You need to go backwards.
No.
Go back!
Well, I don't want to talk about Danganronpa. I want to talk about Jack eating himself to death. That's something I understand. I understand it, man.
Much better. Much better. Okay. I think I do need to get going.
Alrighty. Should probably head out too. Yeah. Start my script writing.
We'll do this again.
Work. Absolutely.
Yeah. Okay. I'm going to move over
here. Talk to y'all later. Thank you for having me.
Yeah.
Of course. It's always fun playing with you guys.
Yeah. What's up? Eventually we'll add a 4th, but right now I'm happy.
Yeah.
Bye, guys. Okay, let's go over here. Yep, still a fucking mess. Okay, yeah. I do need to go do stuff. I was expecting this to be like 5 hours, but I'm happy with 4. Let's see who we can raid. I hope that was fun, guys. And like I said, I'll be back tomorrow at 4 p.m. for a charity Among Us stream hosted by Patty Cakes. You know what? I haven't raided Leaf, so let's do that.
There is a free one.
And then Tuesday, I haven't talked to Fool, but we're probably going to play Stray Gods unless something comes up. And then probably won't hear from me for a bit. And by that, I mean, like, Sunday. Because it's a weird schedule. I might do a fourth, but I don't think I will, but maybe. We'll see. I'll keep you guys informed. But yeah, enjoy Leaf Displays. He's a good guy. If you didn't see our interview with him last week, I recommend it. And I will see you guys tomorrow. Peace.
Crossbow! Ooh, crossbow! Bog! Good timing! Hello, Silver Fang! What were you playing? Yeah, thank you so much for the raid! What were you playing, man? So right now this was pre on the Epic game, so I'm playing right this thing. Oh wait, what's this? Oh, what? Oh. Oh, Civ 6. That's like the RTS game, right? Yeah, I remember playing that thing maybe like not number 6, mostly like the older one, I think. Yeah, I used to play those things when I was a kid a lot. Ooh, ammo. He is watching. We can't leave. Oh, we can't.